Hello and welcome to WZBC Newton 90.3 FM. My name is Jacob Lassner. I am joined alongside in the booth by Reynolds Johnson and Brendan Mahoney. And you are tuned in to tonight's coverage of the Hockey East semifinals between the Boston College Eagles and the Boston University Terriers. Guys, how are we feeling tonight?
Feel pretty good. I think it's going to be a good hockey game. You know, I think at the beginning of the season, people could have predicted this would be the matchup in the Hockey East Championship, and here we are, number one versus number two, BC versus BU. It doesn't get better than that. As I'm sure some people saw, I used that exact wording on my tweet for the ZBC account, but yeah, it feels good.
Yeah, and Reynolds, how are you doing tonight?
Pretty good. Really excited to see where each of these teams are going to end up today. I think, you know, this could really establish who the best team in college hockey is. I'm sure each fan will have their opinion, but number one going against number two, that always seems to have the definitive answer for the question.
Yeah, absolutely, guys. And now to just give a little bit of a preview as these teams are getting ready to come out onto the ice. Let's first take a look at the Boston University Terriers lineup. First up on that first line, they've got Shane LaChance, centered by Macklin Celebrini, and then Jack Harvey to the right of him. Guys, what can we expect from those three tonight?
Shane LaChance, also known as Jack Parker's grandson, is a massive player, a player whose physicality dominates the game. And along with Macklin Celebrini and Jack Harvey, who has proved to be a little bit of a liability, one of the only liabilities on this BU team, is an interesting combination. Harvey and Celebrini have played a lot together, but LaChance and Celebrini haven't, so something to look out for.
Second line, the Northeastern transfer, Jack Hughes, centered by Ryan Green, and Quinn Hudson is on the right on that line. Quinn Hudson, a sophomore out of North Barrington, Illinois. He is a brother of Lane Hudson, and they've got a few other brothers that are destined for NHL stardom. Can you talk a little bit about what Jack Hughes brings to that second line?
Jack Hughes brings experience. 4 years at Northeastern. He has a lot of Hockey East playoff experience, including Hockey East or Beanpot Championships, to say the least, which are played at TD Garden. So that's some level of experience there. And Ryan Green and Quinn Hudson are two outstanding players. There really isn't a bad player on this BU roster.
Absolutely. Third line, Jeremy Wilmer, centered by Nick Zabine, and then Dylan Peterson on the right. Nick Zabine is a guy, he's a grinder kind of forward. He's going to get into the corners, he's going to try to get under your skin, as well as we were noting last night, Brendan, he is a terrific skater.
I was going to say, he might be one of the best skaters in the Hockey East, if not the best skater. His turns are phenomenal. He may not be the most skilled guy, but he is a terrific skater, which allows him to have control of the puck a lot of the time, just because he beats other people to the puck.
Yeah, and when we look at that third line, I see Jeremy Wilmer, a guy with 36 points in 36 games, a Rockville Center, New York native, close to my home. It's not often you see a guy with 36 points on the third line. And then when we get to that fourth line of BU, I think this line has the potential to be the most lethal line of the night for Boston University. This line could be a first line on any team in the NCAA. Luke Tuck, Sam Stevens, and Devin Kaplan make up that line. Sam Stevens, tremendous faceoff man for this Boston University team. He's over 50% on faceoffs on the year, and he's improved every year since he got to Boston University. He also won the Clark Cup at Sioux Falls before Boston University. He has 15 points on the year. He is from Montreal, Quebec. Brendan and Reynolds, what can you guys tell me about that line for Boston University? Are they
like you said, it's a line that could be a first line in a lot of schools. You know, Sam Stevens, everybody's favorite dirty player, is a talented player. He's a grindy player. And now we hear some chants of FBU and some boos back. It's going to be a testy crowd tonight. The atmosphere is incredible at TD Garden.
Absolutely. A lot of BC fans here can't really say the same about BU students, but the BC students really came to play tonight. And then on the defensive side of the puck for Boston University, Reynolds, can you talk a little bit about Lane Hudson and what he brings to the table for his future team, the Montreal Canadiens?
He's just absolutely phenomenal when he has the puck in his hands. The only player that BC really has that emanates his style is Eamon Powell, but Lane Hudson is just another level. I mean, he's clearly destined to be a star in the NHL. People always bring up his size. It doesn't matter when you see the way he skates, the way he maneuvers around the puck, the way he's able to coordinate the offense. And he's a huge reason that their power play is almost at 30%.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, that Boston University power play was huge last night against the Maine Black Bears. Lane Hudson scored a terrific goal against the Black Bears. Brendan, what did we see on that goal?
It's, Jacob, you and I were talking while we were watching the game. It's not if they score a goal, it's when.
Yes.
Against that Maine team. Maine with a lacking of defense, something BC doesn't have. BC has a very strong defensive core. But, you know, this BU Terriers team is lethal on the power play. So BC needs to avoid taking penalties at all costs.
Absolutely. And then on the second D pairing, Cade Weber. Brendan, this is a guy that you're very high on this Boston University team. And he's paired along with Tom Willander. Can you talk a bit about Cade Weber and how big he is for this BU defense? No pun intended.
Yeah, Cade Weber is a massive player. But beyond that, he averages almost 8 blocked shots a game. Truly a tremendous number for a player of his size to be able to use his body and absorb contact. And that's something that maybe he needs to continue to do tonight to make Matthew Perron's job a little bit easier. Because
yes.
Perron is not the type who's going to make those big saves. So Perron needs a lot of help with the people.
Yeah, absolutely. And let's get to Matthew Perron. Brendan, we talked about this on Sports Saturday Today. How do the Eagles break through on Matthew Perron, who's been on a bit of a hot streak recently?
Yeah, Matthew Perron, it's just pelted him with shots. Maine didn't get a lot of shots up on him last night. The atmosphere is just so incredibly overwhelming. These BC students are rocking this place.
Absolutely. And now let's transition to the Boston College side of the puck. Oscar Yelvey, Cutter Gauthier, Andre Gasso on that first line for BC. Now Reynolds, what do you think about that first line for Boston College?
It brings tears to my eyes, Jacob. It's so beautiful. Just Oscar Yelvik, who's taken leaps and bounds since last year. Cutter Gauthier, who's arguably the best player in the nation and is an NHL ready. And Andre Gasso, who's gotten better just about every game he's played this season. It's something to behold.
Yeah, absolutely. Last night, Andre Gasso scored an incredibly pretty goal against UMass, where Cutter Gauthier seemingly put the puck behind him and fed it right to Gasso, right in the slot, and he just buried it. He had all the net to put the puck in. Second line for BC, perhaps the most exciting line in the country, the most dynamic line in the country. Gabe Perreault, Will Smith, and Ryan Leonard. Reynolds, what is the addition of Gabe Perreault to this Eagles lineup that lacked that Gabe Perreault aspect to their game these past few weeks?
Two goals and just chemistry. It's clear when Gabe Perreault is back, everyone understands their assignments so much better than without him. You get flashbacks to last weekend where that line just played abysmal defense. Cutter Gauthier wasn't looking great. Chemistry wasn't there. As soon as you get Gabe Perreault back, they're scoring again. They're blocking shots. It's just much more cohesion on the offense and defensive side.
Absolutely. And then that third line for Boston College, Jamie Armstrong, Jack Malone, and Colby Ambrosio. Talk to me a little bit about Colby Ambrosio and his veteran status on this team, Brendan.
Yeah, Colby Ambrosio, personal favorite of mine, good friend of mine as well. Colby Ambrosio is a gritty player who in the first few years of his career had a lot of time on those first two lines, but that's kind of gone down with a lot of star power that BC has. So Colby's been able to take up his role on the third and fourth line this season.
Got it. So a packed house here at TD Garden. We're going to break for the national anthem. Here it is.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please drop and sit up in your caps and welcome Shay Brinkman, as she honors America with the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed?
welcome to WZBC Newton once again, 90.3 FM. My name is Jacob Lassner. I'm joined alongside by Brendan Mahoney and Reynolds Johnson. We are here to bring you live coverage of the 2024 Hockey East Championship live from TD Garden. We are honored to bring you firsthand coverage of these two amazing college hockey teams, two of the best college hockey teams in the history of college hockey, Brendan.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think that if someone wanted to tell me these are the two best teams in the history of college hockey, I would probably be okay with that. They go both belong in the top five for sure. Two incredible teams. You know, this is their fourth meeting this season. Last time they were at the Garden, BU got away with that one because of a slow start from BC. BC leads the season series 2-1.
Yeah, and now Reynolds, how can BC avoid that kind of game that they had at TD Garden last time they played against Boston University?
I don't think you let yourselves get down 2-0 early. Mack and Celebrini had a phenomenal first period, scoring two magnificent goals. And if the Eagles can eliminate that, make him not the X factor that he is when he's on the ice, and just kind of steer them towards a more favorable path for the rest of the game, I think that's the key, just shutting down Mack and Celebrini and making sure we're the ones who get take it first.
Yes, absolutely, Reynolds. So we're about to get started here at TD Garden. Cutter Gauthier on the right of him, Andre Gasso, Oscar Jelvik to the left. And on defense, Drew Fortescue and Eamon Powell. On the Boston University side, Macklin Celebrini, the projected number one overall draft pick in next year's draft, along with Shane LaChance and Jack Harvey to the left of them. So BC wins the faceoff. They're going to dump it all the way down. Andre Gasso has the puck in the corner, taps it to Gauthier. It's up top. Fortescue takes a shot. It goes wide. Lane Hudson trying to clear the zone for Boston University, and he does. No icing on the play as the ref rules that it goes off a BC stick. It's in the BC defensive zone. Shane LaChance trying to dig for the puck, can't do it. Here's Fortescue breaking it out for Boston College, plays it off the glass. Lane Hudson has it for BU, over for LaChance. LaChance head up, sends it all the way down for BU, and they're going to go for a change. Second line hops out for the Terriers. Jack Hughes is on the puck at the blue line. He sends it all the way down. Expletives being yelled out from the crowd. Here's Fortescue down the left-hand side. He's looking for an option. Decides to send it all the way down. Goes off the shin pad of the referee, and here comes BU the other way. Here's Ryan Green. Backhands it into the zone for the Terriers. Drew Fortescue on the puck again for BC. Over for Smith, taps it for Leonard. Into the neutral zone he goes, down the right-hand side. Has it poked off his stick, takes a shot, it goes wide. All the way to the point for Hershuck. He sends it in deep, hits the referee again. Here's Leonard, over for Perreault. Perreault loses track of the puck, and here comes Jack Hughes the other way. And then Ryan Green sends it all the way down. Not much going on in these first few seconds of the period here, Brendan.
Yeah, really passive play from both teams. They're kind of just sending it. BC had some sort of ish shots. I wouldn't even call them shots, but yeah, kind of a soft game so far.
Yeah, here's Malone. He sends it in deep for Boston College to the right of Caron. Peterson trying to get it out for Boston University. Bengston has it in the neutral zone, goes back into the defensive zone, and referee has his arm up. What's the call?
It's going to be Jack Malone with a trip, I think, yeah.
Yep.
Jack Malone's foot got the caught of, I forget whose player it was, but he just got his foot underneath and slew-footed him.
So,
not how you wanted to start.
Yeah, definitely not, Reynolds. What can we expect to see from BU on this power play, Reynolds?
A lot of Lane Hudson and a lot of Macklin Celebrini. Those are the guys who quarterback this. Macklin Celebrini, obviously over 30 goals this season, projected number one. Lane Hudson, the quarterback. And he's a huge part of that success in the power play, almost 30%.
Absolutely. Shane LaChance taking the draw against Mike Posma. For the Eagles, Jack Malone, their best penalty killer, is sitting in the box. Pucks at the point, Lane Hudson. Center point, down low, Celebrini. Celebrini looking for a shot, she takes it. Save made, Fowler. Green Hudson with a shot, it's blocked by Minetian. Minetian chops it out of the zone for BC, right onto the stick of Posma. He sends it all the way down. Caron comes out of his net to play it. What do we see on that play there, Brendan?
Yeah, it got out of hand a little bit quick. Macklin got a great shot off, but a good recovery by Minetian and Posma on that one.
Yep, 17:47 to go in the first period. BU rins the puck all the way down to their offensive zone. They have 1:27 to go on their power play. Here's Bengston, taps it forward. Gauthier trying to play it out of the zone, kept in by Hudson, it's in front, Green. He's stick checked by Gauthier. Here's a 2-on-1 the other way. Jelvik, he's got Gauthier springing to the net, trying to find Gauthier. Puck goes under his stick. Macklin Celebrini on the puck, gets it over for Lane Hudson. Down the left-hand side, he enters the offensive zone. Hudson across for Celebrini. Puck goes under his stick. Kaplan for Celebrini. Now it's Lachance in the corner. Plays it up top for Kaplan, and it escapes his grasp. 56 seconds to go on the power play. Jelvik blocks a pass, and he sends it all the way down. 17:04 to go in the first period. 0-0 remains the score.
Yeah, active stick work here by the BC Eagles to poke a lot of pucks away from BU.
Absolutely. Here's Hughes. Gets it across for Wilmer. Now it's back for Hughes. Back for Wilmer. Down low, below the circle. He's looking for an option. Finds McCarthy. Over for Hughes. Left point shoots, and it goes wide. Wilmer gets the rebound, sends it over for McCarthy at the point. Across for Hughes, who takes a shot right into the chest of Fowler with 16:33 to go in the first period. 19 seconds to go on the power play for Boston University.
If I'm a BC fan, I'm really happy with the kill so far. Again, it's not like we really prevented shots. It's we prevented good shots from this BU power play, which is really deadly overall, as we saw last night versus Maine.
So
exactly, just try to keep him to the outside.
Yep. So two shots on the power play so far for Boston University. Luke Tuck takes the draw and wins it. Back for Willander. Willander off the boards for Jack Hughes. Posma takes it away, trying to get it out. Can't do it. Over for Fortescue below the goal line. He sends it all the way down for BC. 8 seconds to go on the power play. Looks like the Eagles have just about killed it off. Here's Willander with his head up in the defensive zone. He's looking for an option. Curls back into the defensive zone and finds Hughes on a backhand pass. Hughes over for Sam Stevens down the left-hand side. Pressured by Eamon Powell. Holding him against the boards is the BC captain. It goes up to Weber at the point. Blocked in front. Fortescue! And a good job by Fortescue of clearing his man in front of the net.
Really happy with the kill. I thought that was really well done. Again, they were getting shots off and firing good passes, but they were not good quality shots. And I think we did a really good job of keeping them on the outside, like Reynolds said, and making sure that the shots Macklin took were not high quality chances for him.
Absolutely. So 15:59 to go in the first period. 0-0 remains the score here at TD Garden. Will Smith slide out there for Boston College. Sam Stevens, Peterson, and Zabine out there for BU. Smith wins the faceoff back for Letty. Below the goal line, he sends it off the boards for Perreault. Perreault skies it out to center, right into the hands of Case McCarthy, the captain of this BU team. Over for his D partner, Weber, and off the boards, back for McCarthy. McCarthy skies it out for Zabine. Goes off his glove, Ryan Leonard takes the puck. They rule it's been played by a hand pass, so the faceoff will go all the way down into the BC defensive zone.
Yeah, kind of an iffy hand pass there. Whatever. It's early in the game. You can see how the refs are going to do the rest of it. But not where you want to be if you're BC right now. You haven't really been able to generate any offense since the penalty kill. But beautiful penalty kill. If you can carry that momentum onto the offensive zone, you know, good things can happen quick.
Absolutely. 15:39 to go in the first period. 0-0 remains the score between Boston College and Boston University. Jack Malone taking the draw against Macklin Celebrini. BU wins it. Here's Gallagher takes a shot. Blockered aside by Fowler into the corner. Ambrosio plays it off the glass. Can't get it out of the zone. Right to Gallagher. Across, Gavin McCarthy shoots one. That one goes off the side of the net, takes an awkward bounce. Minetti loses his stick, ruled a slash on Boston University. So BC will go to the power play. Few tic-tac calls called by these referees, guys.
Yeah, if they're going to call it one way, I think that's good that they called it the other. Shane Lachance absolutely chopped at Aaron Minetti's stick. I think that's a good call overall, based on the Hockey East reffing precedent. And in my opinion, BC really, really needs to get good chances here and probably a goal.
Absolutely. So Cutter Gauthier, Ryan Leonard, Gabe Perreault, Eamon Powell, and Will Smith. The star-studded penalty power play line for Boston College takes the ice first. Gauthier set to take the draw against Ryan Green. He wins it, ties him up, and it goes to Smith. Left point, Powell, right point. He's looking for an option. Down low for Gauthier, top of the circle. Back for Powell at the point. Now it's Smith at the other point. Powell's center point, looking for an option. He's pivoting. Skating backwards, back for Will Smith at the center point. Takes a shot, blocked in front by Weber. Now it's Gabe Perreault, below the goal line for BU. BC, over for Leonard. Can't put it in. McCarthy trying to clear it out for BU. He has it in the corner. Oh, for Green, and he's going to send it all the way down the length of the ice. Jacob Fowler taps it over for Eamon Powell. Powell over for Smith. Reaches for the puck in the neutral zone. Sends it all the way in for Gauthier at the point, who takes a shot. It goes wide right to the stick of Ryan Leonard at the top of the right circle. Over for Perreault. coasting over for Gauthier at the faceoff dot, blocked by Kate Weber. Once again, here's Gauthier at the hash marks, down low for Perreault below the goal line. Perreault back for Gauthier at the hash marks, moves towards the faceoff dot and sends it up top for Powell. At the right point, he is. Now it's Smith at the hash marks of the left circle, throws it in front, Dave Perreault scores! It could have gone off McCarthy in front of the BU net, but either way, it looks like Will Smith has a goal for Boston College with 14:14 to go in the first period.
Exactly, it's those grindy chances that you have to have against a great defensive team like BU. Just bouncing puck around, an active six in front of the net, and Will Smith was able to control that one.
Yeah, it looks like Will Smith takes it down below the center dot. It looks like it goes off the skate of number eight. That's going to be Cade Weber's skate. So Will Smith goal there.
Yeah, so Will Smith scores first for Boston College, even though I thought Gabe Perreault might have gotten a stick on it. BC jumps out to an early lead with 14:14 to go in the first period. Malone and Gasso digging for the puck at the faceoff dot in center ice. It's in the neutral zone. Gasso across. Bankston sends it in deep for BC. It's in the corner. Lane Hudson gets there first, trying to get it out of the zone. Taps it forward for Hughes. Now it is at the blue line. Over for Willander, who carries the puck in for BU. Jelvik has it for BC now. One hands it over for Bankston in the defensive zone. Now it's Gustafsson. Puck slips away from him. Ryan Greet has it at the hash marks. Up top, he sends it across. Willander to his D partner, Hudson, looking for a pass. At the hash marks, he sends it in front. Jack Hughes trying to bury it. Or actually, that was Quinn Hudson trying to bury it. He could not get a stick on it. And then Jack Hughes plays it into the BC bench. So the faceoff will come out of the BC defensive zone.
Oh my God, Lane Hudson just cutting up and dicing, doing mohawks, throwing everything he can just to throw off the BC defender right there. As it will find a wide open Quinn Hudson right there. Yeah, it's
talented player.
So impressive.
Really nothing else to say, but wow, he is a talented player.
Yeah, we saw it in the first game against Maine last night, and we see it here again tonight. Lane Hudson is going to be the X factor along with Macklin Celebrini for this Boston University team. Now, guys, I don't know. It seems like BU has controlled the offense, their offensive zone for most of the game. What's the key for Boston College to kind of break the puck out and get some more possession in their offensive zone?
I just think a lot of passing. I think passing and quick passing is the key to that.
I think if the Eagles keep playing defense the way they've been playing, I'd like to see them a bit stronger on their sticks, a bit stronger on the puck. You're doing a good job of keeping to the outside and minimizing those high-quality chances. It's just when you get a pass like that to the center and no one's there, that's when you're going to run into danger.
Absolutely, guys. And, I mean, that star power that Boston College has is another X factor for this team. 13:30 to go in the first period. BC is up 1-0. We're in the midst of a media timeout here, but I've decided to keep talking. I'm looking in the YouTube chat right now. Have some BU fans in there.
All I have to say to that is scoreboard.
So 1-0 remains the score. 13:30 to go in the first period. Goal was scored by Will Smith for Boston College, and it went off the skate of the shot blocking maestro Cade Weber for Boston University.
I believe the NCAA stats people are reviewing and have in the past couple minutes about who they're actually crediting the goal to, but doesn't really matter. A goal's a goal.
Absolutely. BU sends the puck into their offensive zone. Looks like there's a missed drop by the referee, so we're gonna have another face-off. 13:25 to go in the first period. BC remains to be up 1-0 in the game.
I can't get over how packed this place is. The Hockey's Championship never brings this type of crowd. It's great to see.
Yeah, absolutely. The lower bowl is almost completely full at TD Garden, and the upper bowl is full of students. Armstrong has it in the BC defensive zone up top for Malone. Sends it across for Ambrosio, who sends it in deep for Boston College. Armstrong is first on the puck. Celebrini takes it away from him. Celebrini over for Harvey, who sends it in deep for BU. No icing. Hershock on the puck, rims it around, trying to find Armstrong. tipped, ends up with Malone. Celebrini trying to take it away from him. And now here's Ambrosio, one-on-one with Lane Hudson. Ambrosio, he had a chance there, but it just escaped his stick. And now it has Hershuk at the point, at the left point, to be specific. Down low for Perreault, trying to feed it across for Malone was Perreault, but it's taken away. And here comes Lane Hudson. He is a marked man out there, guys. But Lane Hudson takes a penalty. BC is going to the power play here. But Aiden Hershuk is down. Here comes Leonard on a breakaway. Shoots one. Save Perron. And the referee has blown the whistle down as Aiden Hershuk is slow to get up here, guys. What did you see on that play?
I think we might actually get a couple penalties, perhaps two on BU and one on BC. I'm not really sure, but I know that Leonard bodied someone down the other end after... Yeah, and Hershuk looks really hurt.
Yeah, it was slow to get up, kind of wins the corners. I, a bit weird. Was that after the trip by Lane Hudson? Or
yeah, this was down the other end. Yeah. Or you're talking about the Hershuk?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a few seconds after. I don't know who hit him, but he didn't get a penalty, whoever hit him.
Yeah.
I guess it's just going to be one penalty on Lane Hudson.
Yeah. So Lane Hudson heads to the box with 12:22 to go in the first period. Eamon Powell and McCarthy are going to have a meeting with the referees at the scorer's box here, as it is unclear about the official ruling on this play.
I think Eamon's asking.
So the face-off is going to be in the BC offensive zone, which makes sense due to the penalty that Lane Hudson just took, which wasn't, I think they ruled it an interference call, guys, or was it roughing?
Wow, it was Macklin with a cross check that wasn't called against Aiden Hershuk. That was a really dirty
hit. Right
from
behind, yeah. His head wasn't quite down, so I understand.
And the puck was nowhere near the play. BC loses the faceoff in the offensive zone. The Eagles are on the power play. BU sends it all the way down the length of the ice. Fowler comes out behind his net to play it for Powell. Powell with the puck still on his stick. Has it in the defensive zone. Over for Perreault. Back for Gauthier, who's going to carry it in. No, wait, he's going to feed Smith, who beats out the icing for Boston College. Smith in front for Powell. High slot shoot, save Caron. It goes into the corner. Will Smith on the puck at the top of the left circle. Over for Powell at the right point. Back for Smith at the center point. Down low for Perreault. Can't get the skate to stick transition. It ends up in the stick of Will Smith, who drops it for Perreault. Perreault back for Smith, trying to feed Leonard in front. Taken away by BU. It's sent all the way down the length of the ice. 1:13 to go on the power play. 11:32 to go in the first period.
Yeah, BU's made a lot of changes to who's going to be on this penalty kill with no Lane Hudson.
Here's Smith with a chance. Scores! Will Smith with his second goal of the game. The San Jose Sharks have got to be proud of that. With 11:23 to go in the first period, the Eagles pull ahead 2-0.
That is his best shot all year, and I'm not exaggerating. I mean, that one-timer comes to mind, but oh my God, top of the circles. Beats him right above the blocker side, top left corner. I mean, that was just an absolute missile. Oh my God, yeah, it doesn't get any more accurate than that. That
great
is just,
shot.
That is a beautiful shot by Will Smith.
Absolutely, Reynolds. I think that I don't think I've seen a better shot from Will Smith all season. I agree with you there. And a terrific celly as well as he reaches behind the back and points towards the crowd of BC students. Tremendous. Or actually towards Jacob Fowler. My apologies there. In any case, Boston College is up 2-0 against Boston University. 11:15 to go in the first period. Here comes Gasso down the right-hand side for BC. Feeds it in front. It goes through a bunch of sticks. Ends up with Malone. Down low, Jelvik rims it for Minettian at the right point. Sends it in deep for Perreault. Goes right under his stick. And now it is Gavin McCarthy, a freshman on this BU team. He was selected in the third round of the NHL draft. Here's Malone. Sends it into the corner for Gasso. In front, Jelvik! Can't get a stick on it. LeChance over for Celebrini. Celebrini's going to carry it in for Boston University. He has it in the defensive zone. Has his head up through the neutral zone he goes. Past the B in the center of the ice. Makes a move at the blue line, and he's going to go offsides. And Aaron Minettian and Aiden Hershuk getting his revenge after the whistle.
Celebrini's getting the works. He's getting absolutely tossed by a lot of BC players. Jack Malone a couple shifts ago, and now Aiden Hershuk and Mike Posma. Aaron Minettian wants all the smoke with Macklin Celebrini.
I mean, he deserves it, too, for that cross check. That's a dirty play by Celebrini there. I mean, typically Golden Boy, he hasn't had many penalty issues, typically known for drawing almost two penalties a game. But on the other hand, I think that, you know, a few minutes ago, that should have been awarded one to BC.
Well, 10:36 to go in the first period. 2-0 is the score in favor of the Boston College Eagles. You're listening to WZBC Newton. Here's Posma in the defensive zone. Over for Fortescue, taken away by BU. It's Ryan Green. Moves up to the point for BU. Sends a pass in deep. McCarthy takes a shot. Save made by Fowler with the shoulder. But BU still has the puck in their offensive zone. Green up top for Lane Hudson. Does a nifty shoulder fake. Camp guest pass, Gentry Schamberger. He takes a shot righty to the glove of Fowler. 10:06 to go in the first period. Jacob Fowler flashes the leather for BC.
When Lane Hudson is out there, that's the time BU looks scariest, and it's not really quite close. He's just able to quarterback the entire play. So shifty with the way he's on his edges. He's just really unpredictable what he's going to do it each time, and BC really hasn't had an answer for him yet.
Yeah, Lane Hudson is going to be the best player on this BU team. And the way that he distributes the puck and also can keep his head up while he skates with the puck is very terrific. Sam Stevens set to take the draw against Will Smith. Face-off tied up by Smith. Gets it over for Gustafson, who is buried into the boards by Kaplan. Leonard carries it into the zone for BC. But here comes BU the other way. Sam Stevens rims it in for the Terriers. Jakob Bengtsson has it in the corner. Over for his D partner. Gustafson plays it off the boards to himself and skies it to center for Gabe Perreault. Perreault trying to stick Pandle past Willander. Kaplan ends up with the puck. Back for Willander. He goes down the right-hand side, trying to feed it through the middle of the ice. Gabe Perreault almost with the interception there. Kaplan taken away by Perreault. Now it is Sam Stevens in the neutral zone. Stevens has it taken away by Smith. And then Smith goes to the ground. No call on the play. Lane Hudson carrying the puck into the zone for BU over for Kaplan, who backhands it in deep. Lucas Gustafson behind Fowler plays it off the boards into the neutral zone. Back for McCarthy, the captain of this BU team. Now it's Weber, who rims it all the way down for the Terriers. Aaron Minetti plays it off the boards for Ambrosio. Errant pass, though. BU takes it away, but Ambrosio recovers on defense. Bengtsson and Wilmer in the corner trying to battle for the puck. Peterson sends it around the boards all the way back into the BU defensive zone.
Really chippy game in these past like five-ish minutes. Going back and forth as we see Peterson's now being ball watch. I guess not ball watch, but right on top of him is Aiden Hershak.
Absolutely. BU sends it all the way down, and that'll be an icing with 8:31 to go in the first period. BC is ahead by two. They lead 2-0.
It's a bit more on that chippy part. I mean, Jamie Armstrong, the turncoat, was just throwing bodies out there looking for someone to hurt. So quick.
And we see on the video board a flag featuring the USA line with Gabe Perreault, Will Smith, and Ryan Leonard with the tagline Step Brothers. Wow, my goodness. That is just
incredible.
A hilarious flag.
Makes me happy to see that on there, as that's my good friend Anthony's. He gave it to our friends in the student section.
Well, in any case, here's McCarthy, the captain of the BU team, in their defensive zone. He has his head up. Feeds Macklin Celebrini. Puck goes through his stick. Eamon Powell has it over for Gauthier, who skies it over LeChance, and then it's played off the glass by BU into their offensive zone. Powell over for Gauthier in the neutral zone. It's by the scorer's box. BU bangs it in to their offensive zone. Eamon Powell and Drew Fortescue out there on defense for the Eagles. Shane LeChance, Jack Harvey, and Macklin Celebrini out there on offense for BU. Here comes Jelvik trying to find Gasso. He can't handle the pass. And it's sent all the way down. Aaron Minetian collects for BC. Plays it forward for Gasso, who tries to find Jelvik. But LeChance takes it away. LeChance over for Harvey. Harvey hit by Hershak, and now it's Jelvik trying to get it back for BC. Harvey in front, over for Celebrini, save Fowler, and another save Fowler as he spreads the eagle and makes two saves for this Eagles team. Here's Hudson at the top of the circle, in front, Celebrini, save made Fowler. Rebound cleared away by BC. Hershak sends it in for Will Smith, who gets it past Hudson in the offensive zone. Back for Leonard, shoots into the glove of Caron. What a dynamic shift for the second line of Boston College.
Yeah, what a transition. Three saves by Fowler, all great ones to Will Smith, headed up the ice, passing it back to Leonard for a missile.
Absolutely. So, 7:04 to go in the first period. 2-0 is the score in favor of Boston College. We're going to take a quick break and send it to Liam in the studio. Getting ready to come back here in five. Hello and welcome back to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner, joined alongside by Reynolds Johnson and Brendan Mahoney here at TD Garden. Will Smith set to take the draw against Ryan Green for Boston University. Will Smith's got two goals on the night for Boston College. 7:04 to go in the first period. USA line out there for BC. Smith wins it back. Gustafson at the center point takes a shot, blocked by Weber in front. Smith down low for Perreault in the corner. Perreault for Leonard, shoots one, steered aside by Caron and played out by BU, but not really. Here's Perreault through the legs, looking for a pass. Has it in the corner. Plays it in front, but it's taken away by Green. Over for Jack Hughes. Past the Bruins logo. Hughes turns, shoots. Save made by Fowler on this off the shot by Green. And here comes Smith the other way. Two-on-two rush for the Eagles. Smith over for Perreault. He moves down low, sends it in. Smith for Minetti and shoots off the stick of Caron. And it goes to the hash marks where Smith cycles it down low for Perreault. Taken away by Hughes. And then he's going to send it in deep for the Terriers. Here's Minetti in the defensive zone for Boston College. Sends it over for Armstrong, who tries to play it off the boards. Luke Tuck meets him there and sends it in deep for the Terriers. Minetti over for Armstrong. Luke Tuck is there, trying to get the puck back for BU. Now it's Sam Stevens, digging against Minetti. Tuck throws a hit on Minetti, knocks him over, but BC has the puck. Gustafson over for Minetti. He plays it off the glass and out of the defensive zone for Boston College. Armstrong can't get the puck back for BC, but Sam Stevens gets there first. Over for Kaplan, over for Tuck. Left-hand side, shoots one. Fowler ramps it off his stick and out of play with 5:24 to go in the first period.
Oh, Luke Tuck went up to Fowler. Fowler wasn't having it, but Minetti wants blood. This rivalry really just makes everything that much more intense.
Yeah. Absolutely.
It's definitely something to behold when both these teams are angry. Both these teams want to win this so much. BU has been trying to prove that they're the better team ever since they won the Beanpot. They had a few slips to Northeastern and a few other teams, but they're an amazing team. BC just had an unbelievable heater ever since they lost that game. Really, a few games of doubt especially come to mind. 2 weeks ago was very rough. But besides that, BC has just looked like the more dominant program over the last few weeks. I mean, skill-wise, talent-wise, depth, goaltending. If BU can win this, maybe they can, you know, shift some of those ideas and misconceptions they think people have about them.
Yeah, and I think BU also wants to win this game because a win would actually help them end up in Springfield as opposed to Sioux Falls in terms of the national tournament. We'll find out those exact pairings tomorrow on the selection show for NCAA hockey, but
Selection Sunday tomorrow for NCAA ice hockey, Brendan, which is always a fun day if you're a college hockey fan. Speaking of college hockey, who made the NCAA Women's Championship, Brendan?
Wisconsin and Ohio State. That game is tomorrow at the Witt at UNH. A great game. Wish I could make it. I totally would have taken a drive up there to see two great women's teams in Ohio State and Wisconsin.
A few former Eagles on that Ohio State team
Kayla
as
Barnes.
Well. Kayla Barnes as well as Hannah Bilka. Headline that lineup. Cutter Gauthier taking the draw against Shane LaChance in the BC defensive zone. To the right of Jacob Fowler. Cutter ties up his man. LaChance rims it around, trying to find Ty Gallagher, a Bruins draft pick, trying to make the squad that plays in this very building. Gallagher keeps it in at the blue line, trying to send it down low for Celebrini. Hershuk taps it for Gasso. Off the boards, Gauthier. Now it's Jelvik. Two-on-two developing for the Eagles. Jelvik. Gauthier trying to get it short side. It goes off the stanchion and into the corner. Here's Harvey over for Celebrini down the right-hand side for BU. Across, Gallagher for Harvey trying to feed. Hudson has it at the point. He moves to the center. Plays a shot on net and it goes right into the breadbasket of Jacob Fowler.
Hudson truly is an incredible skater. He has this ability to skate sideways so well so that his body is facing the net, but he can move laterally. It's truly so impressive. He's a phenomenal skater.
Just to add on top of that, he uses puck protection as well. You see his mohawks. I mean, he's done that several times around the side marks of the bot. It's beautiful the way he handles the puck. I mean, I wish BC could have him, honestly.
Absolutely. It kind of reminds me of, obviously, Cale Makar. When he was in college at the University of Massachusetts, he won the national title with them and back in 2020. BC wins the faceoff, back for Powell. Over for Schamberger, fourth line out there for Boston College. Posma plays it off the glass. Can't get it in deep for BC. Zabinet has it for the Terriers. Over for Weber. Or that was Willander. Back for Zabinet, past the Bruins logo. Zabinet with a burst of speed takes a shot blocked by Fortescue. Into the corner it goes. Cade Weber on the pinch trying to get it. It's Peterson. Schamberger takes it away from him. Two on one developing. Schamberger with Joyce. Schamberger trying to find Joyce. Weber takes the lane away from Joyce. Posma tries to throw a big hit on Wilmer. And he just narrowly missed, but
looks like
we're going to get a penalty on the play. So the Terriers will go to the power play with 3:59 to go in the first period. They trail 2-0.
I don't really like that call. I think the puck was well within the vicinity. I don't like that call.
I think it caught him a bit high. That's what the refs are looking for.
Yep. 2-minute minor, however, even though Mike Posma did get a little high on that hit. Can't say I agree with the
call. They call it tripping? Yeah.
Well, in any case, it's what you get in the Hockey East Championship. You get Hockey East refs. 3:59 to go in the first period. Boston College leads 2-0. Hershuk for Armstrong, who sends it in deep all the way down. Caron comes out of his net to play it, leaves it for Hudson. Over for LaChance in the neutral zone. Sends it in deep for the Terriers. Aiden Hershuk trying to get it out for BC. Can't do it. Ryan Green, it's at the blue line and slips into the neutral zone. Lane Hudson has it, trying to play it in front. He still has it on his puck. Minetian trying to take it away. Down low for his brother Quinn. Quinn plays it across for Celebrini. Leonard's on him. LaChance has it behind the net of BC. Minetian takes it away from him, but the other 17 has it now. Lane Hudson at the point. Across for Macklin Celebrini. Back for Hudson. Now it is Celebrini, right point. Down low, Hudson, top of the circle. Another Hudson takes a shot, it ends up on the stick of Macklin Celebrini. Lane Hudson takes a shot, it's blocked by Malone. And then Quinn Hudson. Over for LaChance. It's behind the net of BC again. Quinn Hudson digs it out in front for his brother Lane. Shoots, blocked by Minetti in front. He gets the elbow on that blocked shot for BC. What'd you see on that play, Brendan?
Minetian got demolished away from the puck by Quinn Hudson. I thought we were going to have a call there. And Macklin with a hit on Leonard. Wow, really physical game.
Absolutely. You can just tell how much these teams hate each other out there. And Gauthier sends it all the way down. 20 seconds to go on the BU power play. 2:15 to go in the first period. 2-0 remains the score here at TD Garden for this Hockey East championship matchup here on WZBC Newton. Here's Hughes. BC's killed off the penalty. Down low for Tuck. Now it is Jack Hughes at the hash marks. Gauthier trying to get the puck back for BC. Goes off the stick of Powell. He backhands it out of the zone, thinking he's on the penalty kill. Ends up going on net, so no icing. Will Smith, Oscar Jelvik, and Gabe Perreault out there for BC as Ryan Leonard was just killing the penalty for the Eagles. McCarthy has the puck. That's Gavin McCarthy. Sends it in for Hughes. Hughes has a break, shoots one. It goes wide. A good block by Drew Fortescue. Hughes blocked again by Fortescue as he tried to feed a pass through the slot. Hughes for McCarthy. He sends it cross corner for Sam Stevens. Fortescue working on him. He rims it to the point. Zabinet is there. Down low for Sam Stevens. Backhands it in deep, trying to find Peterson. Peterson has it in the corner. Oscar Jelvik digging for the puck. But it is Zabinet who has it now. Over for Peterson again below the goal line. Up top for McCarthy. Now it is Peterson. 1 minute to go in the period here. 2-0 is the score in favor of Boston College. Will Smith plays it out of the zone. Oscar Jelvik wins the race to get there first. Trying to play it in front, but it's blocked by McCarthy. Over for Peterson, and now it is. I believe that's Gavin McCarthy with the puck. Drops it, Peterson shoots, save Fowler with the chest, and here comes Perreault the other way. Perreault, Armstrong, and Ambrosio. 3-on-2 rush. Trying to find Ambrosio was Perreault, but he's gonna go for a change now. BU has it going the other way. Jack Harvey in the corner. Hershuk over for Gustafson. Now it is Ambrosio at the hash marks. Sends it back in deep. Trying to get it out, but it's Lane Hudson. Across for Lachance. It's blocked in front by Hershuk. And then Armstrong's gonna clear it into safe territory for Boston College. Ambrosio over for Gasso. Now it is Celebrini. 1 second to go in the period, and that'll do it. Here on WZBC Newton, the score is 2-0. The first period has just concluded. Now before we head into break, guys, any thoughts on that period?
Defensive clinic in the last 5 minutes by the Eagles. It doesn't matter if it was Drew Fortescue, Aaron Minetti, and Eamon Powell. Their sticks, their bodies, and they're so tough out there. I think I counted 6 block shots between those 3 guys alone. I mean, it was just a thing of beauty, just being able to completely eliminate the Terriers offense.
Yeah, I completely agree. Really well done by the Eagles defensively. Obviously, people are going to look back at those 2 goals, but I'm going to look at the defensive play on that one.
Absolutely, I'd agree. BC's defense looked phenomenal in that period, blocking shots when they needed to. And their best defender, Jacob Fowler, stood tall as BU shot the puck 12 times on goal, and he saved all of them. Well, the score is 2-0. You're listening to WZBC Newton. We're going to send it back for Liam in the studio with Eleanor. Thanks, guys. We'll be back in 15. getting ready to come back here. We'll give you 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hello and welcome to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner, and you're listening to 90.3 FM WZBC Newton. We're here with coverage of the Hockey East Finals between Boston College and the Boston University Terriers. Now, Reynolds, we were just talking in the break about some key statistics going into the second period. Can you bring up a few of them?
For the Eagles, some key players have been Drew Fortescue and Aaron Minetti, each with a pair of three block shots. Super impressive. I think half those came in the last few seconds of the shift. And also, three shots apiece already for Cutter Gauthier, or not Cutter, excuse me, Will Smith and Ryan Leonard, both just absolute missiles of shots. And Will Smith was fortunate enough to bury that second shot he had. Beautiful. But one thing also, I just noticed the USA line, the freshman line, they're all walking, they're rocking some interesting tape jobs today. It looks like they've got a little black and white checkered flag combination going on for Gabe Rowe. Ryan Leonard had cobwebs, I think. I'm not certain, but it's looking good.
Yeah, the style is unmatched by the second line of Boston College. Well, the time has come. The second period is about to begin here at TD Garden. My name is Jacob Lassner. I am joined alongside by Reynolds Johnson and Brendan Mahoney. Second period action starts right now on WZBC Newton. BC wins the opening faceoff. Hershock has it in the defensive zone, sends it forward for Minetti, who sends it in deep for Boston College. Now shooting on the opposite net from last period because, obviously, it's hockey. Another statistic I want to mention is that the Eagles won the faceoff battle 10-8 in the last period, something the Eagles have really wanted to work on all season. Here comes Macklin Celebrini. He plays it forward. Shane LeChance with a breakaway chance, but Aaron Minetti negates that one. Now it's Harvey. Over for LeChance, trying to find Celebrini. Gauthier takes it away. Here he comes, down the right-hand side. Cuts to the middle, looks for a shot. Blocked by Hudson, and played over the net, and caught by a fan.
Wow.
My goodness. Of course, a Boston College fan grabs that one. 19-14 to go in the second period. The Eagles are down two, or are up, sorry, 2-0 over the Boston University Terriers.
Great maneuvers there by Cutter Gauthier. First, he kind of flipped the puck to himself, able to give him speed down the side. Then a great quick cut in, and unfortunately shot blocked, but great opportunity by Gauthier there.
So, Will Smith set to take the draw in the offensive zone for Boston College. He's going against Ryan Green. Smith, Perreault, and Leonard out there. Smith ties up his man on the draw, taps it, Perreault in the slot, Hughes takes it away from him, Perreault gets it back, feeds it in front through the stick of Leonard, here comes Quinn Hudson the other way, over for Hughes. Hughes, toe drag release, takes one on Fowler, who gets it with the shoulder, and covers it up, helmet falls off, and he reveals his mullet to the fans sitting in the lower sections of TD Garden.
Yeah, as we hear the ugly goalie chant rain in from the BU fans. Sadly, I don't think they've seen Matthew Perron's face.
I don't know. I mean, I think it's because he's ginger. He can't really see much other than that up here.
Will Smith loses the draw. BU has it in the offensive zone. Shot on goal, blocked in front by BC. Willander pinching in the corner. Over for Hughes up top. Gavin McCarthy takes a shot, and it's saved by Fowler. He's gonna gobble it up and hold on to it with 8:47 to go in the second period.
Yeah, that was actually a little bit loose for a second. I think they blew the whistle before Fowler actually had it, which is lucky. Yeah, I think he collected right, yeah. So, well, regardless, he was gonna get it, so all that matters.
Yeah, so shots on goal total in this game, 14 for Boston University and 8 for Boston College. BU winning the shot battle, and BC not really getting a lot of chances, 5-on-5, guys, 5-on-5. But Gavin McCarthy has it at the point. He sends it in deep, Ryan Green goes to chase it. He's at the hash mark, sends it up top, Lane Hudson takes a shot, it just goes wide. You gotta think he's gonna hit the net on one of those shots here, guys.
Let's hope not.
Hudson, high slot, loses it. Hughes, down low, takes a fall, tapped out of the zone by Ambrosio, and now it's Gustafson. He's going to send it in gingerly into the offensive zone for BC.
Great skating by Jamie Armstrong to catch up to Lane Hudson.
Bankston takes a shot. It goes wide. Armstrong trying to get the puck back for BC. It ends up at the point. Bankston takes another shot. Caron blockers it away into the corner. It's up at the point, and it escapes Lucas Gustafson. He's going to skate it all the way back into the defensive zone. Now it's Armstrong the other way in the offensive zone. Armstrong, Ambrosio, short side, can't put it in.
Kobe Ambrosio's going to get one right there.
Yeah, Kobe Ambrosio can't buy a goal at this point, guys.
It's tough.
He had plenty of room there, too. I really like that shot attempt, just trying to sneak it by. Had maybe about 4 inches in between the pad and the post right there.
Well, in any case, 2-0 remains the score in favor of Boston College. 17:50 to go in the second period. Mike Posma, Gentry Schamberger, and Connor Joyce out there for BC. Posma wins the faceoff. Joyce taps it back for Powell. Powell goes to the other side of the ice and sends it in deep. Sam Stevens gets there first. He plays it off the glass right to Connor Joyce. He shoots one, tipped in front by Posma and then gobbled up by Caron.
More offensive zone faceoffs, the better. I don't know if Greg Brown's gonna keep the same line. I respect it. I would have liked to see a change to maybe that top two lines, get into some offense, maybe a mismatch on the draw.
Well, Connor Joyce's line remains out there for Boston College. Joyce takes the draw against Sam Stevens in the offensive zone. Joyce wins the faceoff. Powell center point looking for an option. Powell shoots, blocked in front by Weber. And he taps it for Stevens, one of the assistant captains of this BU team. Willander passed the Bruins logo into the offensive zone, poked away by Letty. It goes off the glass. Sam Stevens gets there first. Gets it up top for Weber. Over for Caplet. Down low, Willander. Jumping up on the play. Errant pass goes all the way down for Boston College. Cade Weber is the first on the puck for the Terriers. He's going to stop up behind the net of Matthew Caron. Picking up the puck is Macklin Celebrini, who had a tough first period. He's looking to get on the score sheet for this Terriers team. Gasso has it at the top of the circle. Over for Jelvik. This could be a chance. Celebrini pokes it away. A tremendous defensive play from the 17-year-old freshman. Minetian in the corner. He blocked 3 shots in the last period. Plays it across to the other corner. McCarthy is there. Over for Lachance behind the net. Lachance met by Gauthier, who's trying to get the puck back for BC. Now it's Minetian who does. Over for Jelvik, and now it's Gasso. Down low for Gauthier, carrying it into the neutral zone for Jelvik, who sends it in deep for the Eagles. Gotta love how Greg Brown has told his squad to get the puck deep no matter what. Here's Gasso. Over for Jelvik, shoots, save Caron. Rebound was there, but he was able to gather it with his stick and hold on with 16:05 to go in the second period.
Yeah, the shots are really raining in on Caron now. Obviously, we scored 2 in the first, so those were technically shots, but I feel like the shots are coming at a higher frequency this period. I will say Caron's done a decent job saving them, but a lot of these are lollipop shots that he really hasn't had to make a lot of big saves. Credit to the BU defense for that.
Absolutely. 16:05 to go in the second period. BC up 2-0 on Boston University. Will Smith, Gabe Perreault, and Ryan Leonard out there take the draw. Green wins it back for McCarthy. Over 4. His brother, Gavin. Now it is Quinn Hudson, speaking of brothers. Ryan Green met by a hit from Bankston at the red line. In the center of the ice, he feeds Case McCarthy, who sends it in deep for the Terriers. Bankston taps it for Gustafson. Green trying to get it for BU. Still behind the net of Fowler. Green comes out with it. Below the goal line, feeds it to the point. Gavin McCarthy scores! His first goal of his freshman career comes in the Hockey East Championship for the Boston University Terriers. The score is 2-1.
Poor defensive shift. They weren't really able to establish themselves on the puck and behind the goals right there. It's just kind of bad defense. They weren't able to do anything. Just leaving him wide open. I mean, Fowler didn't really have much obstructing him there either.
So Jacob Fowler couldn't really see the shot coming from Gavin McCarthy. It might have went off a BC stick. In any case, the score is 2-1. This game has more stories to tell. The Battle of ComAv in the Hockey East Championship. Ty Gallagher has it, sends it into the neutral zone and into the offensive zone for the Terriers. Zabine collects behind the net of Fowler, over for Ambrosio. Sends it for center support for Armstrong. It's too hard to handle for him. It ends up in the neutral zone. Zabine, drop pass, Peterson, down low, below the goal line, over for Wilmer. Spins off a hit, feeds it over for Peterson. Now it's Lane Hudson at the center point. Down low, Wilmer, bumper pass, can't find his man in the slot. Connor Joyce trying to get it out for BC, he does. And a bit of a scrum going on in the middle of the ice between Jamie Armstrong and Lane Hudson. Hudson a little slow to get up, he looks to be grabbing his shoulder. But here Stevens takes the shot, blockered away by Fowler. And then sent in to the offensive zone by BU, but Cutter Gauthier receives it in the neutral zone. Gauthier across. Trying to find his man, and it goes all the way into the BC defensive zone for an icing on this Boston University Terriers team.
Yeah, the coach on the bench right there is red as a tomato. BC got away with a pretty blatant interference right there.
Yeah, it was Jamie Armstrong interfering with Lane Hudson, but no call from these Hockey East referees. We've seen it go both ways here, guys.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think, you know, BU's gotten away with a lot of cross checks and dirty plays, so I can't say that any BU fan should be upset at a no call there.
Absolutely. BU wins the draw in their defensive zone. Willander trying to get it out, can't. It ends up at the point. Cutter Gauthier and Lucas Gustafson with the puck. Gauthier at the top of the circle, taken away by Luke Tuck. His brother is on the Buffalo Sabres. Alex Tuck, a BC alum. As the BU Civ chant rings loud here in TD Garden. Gabe Perreault, or Andre Gasso, sends it in deep for the Eagles. Willander on the backhand, plays it out for Weber. Now it's Kaplan. Into the neutral zone he goes, past the Bruins logo. In on Fowler, the puck goes. Taps it over for Jelvik, who sends it all the way down for BC. Willander off the boards for McCarthy. McCarthy has it on his backhand, trying to get it out of his dome. Over for Macklin Celebrini. Moves past Letty, into the middle of the ice, over for Harvey. Save Fowler with the shoulder, and it goes out of play. What a save from the BC netminder, but things are getting a little scary for the Boston College Eagles here, guys.
Yeah, we've looked kind of sloppy. Cutter's thrown two errant passes, one to a player who was going onto the bench, and another just across the ice to nobody. I think we're a little shaken up. I think Greg Brown in this break is just going to say, relax. We still have the lead, but relax.
Yep.
Everyone looks a little bit rattled.
I'd like to see more out of that second line, if I'm being honest. Like, as Cutter Gauthier had a very poor shift there, and forecheck could easily beat the defender there and just kind of slowed down, went for the hit. Kind of just more effort out of your top players. I mean, the freshman line, they've done their duty. They put up two goals. Their defense has been lacking, but, you know, they're still up one on the day.
Absolutely, Reynolds. There's a big challenge upcoming for this BC team to fend off the attack from the BU Terriers right now. BU leads the shot total 17-12 at the current moment. 13:29 to go in the second period. 2-1 is the score between the Terriers and the Eagles. Guys, do you see enough out of the second line for BC right, or the freshman line for BC right now?
I think they just need a little bit more ice time before anything else. I think Greg Brown leaned really heavy on those bottom two lines to start this period, and I think we need a little bit more even disbursement.
Yeah, I would agree with that, Brendan. And it looks like they're going to start off after this brief timeout here. 13:29 again to go in the second period. BC trails Boston University 2-1. You're listening to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner alongside Brendan Mahoney and Reynolds Johnson. Face off to the left of Jacob Fowler. I will say, guys, BU did win the Oreo Challenge last night. They win it again here tonight.
That's a gut punch right there.
Absolutely. Here's Minedian in the defensive zone for BC, off the glass, sends it all the way down for BC. And that'll be an icing as BU gets there first.
Wow.
An Altar Boys chant breaks out in this BU student section, who we are standing above at the present moment. Face off to the right of Jacob Fowler. Shane LaChance, Jack Harvey, and Macklin Celebrini out there. Cutter Gauthier, Andre Gasso, and Oscar Yelvie out there for BC. Here's Hudson. Dangles past Gasso. Feeds it down low for Harvey, who takes a spill to the ice. Minedian comes out with the puck. Now it is Gauthier, past the Bruins logo, taken away by Hudson. In for Harvey, taken back by Hershuk. Into the neutral zone it goes. Oscar Yelvie drops it. Gasso! Trying to move past two BU players, can't do it. Celebrini in a race with the puck with Hershuk. Hershuk gets there first, plays it off the boards for his D partner, who at this moment is Fortescue. Gauthier at the blue line, has it on the backhand, sends it in deep. Hudson gets there first, trying to send his brother, Quinn Hudson, on a breakaway pass, but it's ruled as an icing as the BC player gets there first, Brendan.
Yeah, thus far, Quinn Hudson is doing a really good job rising the rankings for dirtiest player at BU. He's getting up there. Good for him. It's one stat that he really could use.
Yeah, he could use some snarl in his game, don't you think, Brendan?
Yeah, no, I meant that in a truly unironic way. I actually think the physicality is really good.
It's important for a player to have that kind of physicality.
Jacob, I see your friend on the Jumbotron right there.
Wow, great to see. A lot of BC students here can't really say the same about BU, but regardless, 12:40 to go in the second period. 2-1 is the score between the Eagles and the Terriers. Here's Leonard, trying to find Smith, taken back by Jack Hughes. Through the middle of the ice, over four, Quinn Hudson, nice dangle past Powell, but it's taken away by Leonard. Green. Over for Quinn Hudson in the neutral zone. Across the ice for Hughes. Takes a shot, Fowler steers it aside into the corner. Taken back though, it is Quinn Hudson at the top of the circle. Feeds it in front, good play by Powell to negate the chance. Here comes Perreault the other way. Over for Leonard, right hand side. Deeks to the middle. Ryan Leonard trying to cut to the slot, can't do it. Jack Hughes going the other way now. Over for Quinn Hudson, who sends a cross corner dump into the BU offensive zone. Minedian gets there first and plays it all the way up for Perreault, who gets it to Smith. Over for Leonard, he shoots one, blocked by Gallagher, and it goes into the corner. Bankston loses a race, Peterson is there for BU. Peterson spun by a hit, over for Gavin McCarthy, the goal scorer for this BU team. Zabinet, top of the slot, shoots, save Fowler. With 11:29 to go in the second period, the Eagles remain up 2-1.
Still thinking about that great shot by Gavin McCarthy. If you had to tell me to guess a BU player that would score a goal, I don't think it would have been Gavin McCarthy. I don't even know if he would have been top 10, but great shot. Gavin McCarthy is doing really well with puck control overall, so thoroughly impressed with that.
Absolutely.
It's all about taking those chances that you're given.
Nick Zabinet sets to take the draw for Boston University against Jack Malone. Third line getting some minutes for this BC team. You're listening to the Hockey East Finals live on WZBC Newton. Face off tied up by Malone. Ends up, Gavin McCarthy takes another shot. It goes wide. Gallagher backhands it in deep to the zone. Peterson has it in the corner. Bankston checking him along with Malone. Bankston off the boards, over for Gustafson. And he skies it out to center for Ambrosio in the offensive zone. He cycles it in deep for Armstrong. Armstrong on the forehand, cycles it in deep, trying to find Ambrosio, but BU gets there first. 10:55 to go in the second period. Armstrong and Malone digging for the puck for the Eagles. Zabinet digs it out for the Terriers first. Off the boards for Wilmer. Met by a hit from Ambrosio, but Ambrosio loses his footing. Means BU has some offensive zone time. Gustafson, though, has it for BC. and BU's going to go for a change. 10:33 to go in the second period.
Big back and forth going on between BC and BU right now. The fans are booing BC for setting up a play.
Here's Gustafson. Through the middle of the ice, sends a pass in deep, right onto the stick of Karan, and he's going to hold on with 10:19 to go in the second period. 2-1 is still the score here on WZBC Newton.
I'd like to see more settled offense out of BC. I think they've struggled doing that. Third line had a great chance right there. I'd like to see third and fourth lines grind them down a bit, change up the pace, get away from our top two lines.
Absolutely. So, Sam Stevens against Connor Joyce is the draw. Battle of third or fourth lines for both these teams. Schamberger over for Powell, shoots into the glove of Karan, it goes. As Lane Hudson knocks Posma down to the ice right as the whistle blows.
This is an interesting little rivalry developing. Mike Posma and Lane Hudson.
Love to see it.
It was getting really chippy in the first period. That's kind of died down a bit.
Just
still
a little,
the same speed.
Do you think that's worked in BU's favor, Reynolds?
I think it has.
Macklin looks less rattled overall.
Absolutely. Mike Posma and Sam Stevens set to go at it in the faceoff dot here to the right of Matthew Karan. Stevens wins the faceoff back, even though an argument could be made that he cheated on the draw. Schamberger barely can keep it into the zone for BC. And then Stevens has it in the neutral zone, but Schamberger takes it away. Here comes Posma down the right-hand side. Drop, Joyce shoots, blocked in front by BU. Posma grinding for the puck in the corner along with Case McCarthy. Posma comes out with it in front for Leonard. Ryan Leonard out there with the fourth line of BC. Here's a shot, Fortescue, blocked by Tuck and sent all the way down by BU. 9:42 to go in the second period, 2-1, still the score. Eamon Powell stops up behind the net of Fowler, has his head up. Sends it to Gauthier in the neutral zone, who taps it in for Gasso in the offensive zone. Ryan Leonard out there with Gasso and Gauthier. Greg Brown mixing up the lines a little bit here, guys. Celebrini plays it off the boards. Gauthier plays it in, but it's offside, so the Eagles are going to regroup and then enter the offensive zone again. Here's Willander down the right-hand side. Taken away by Gasso, sent in deep. Gauthier in a race with the puck with Weber, who gets there first. That long reach of Weber is key, guys. Here's Leonard, loses it. Here's Celebrini going the other way. Macklin Celebrini past the B logo in the middle of the ice. Minettian does a good job of fending off the incoming first overall pick. Harvey loses the puck. Leonard over for Gauthier in the neutral zone. Hoot sends it cross ice for Minettian. Puck jumps over his stick. Now it's Hudson over for Willander. Over for Celebrini in the neutral zone. Oh, and here comes LaChance on the backhand, shoots one. Fowler gets it with the shoulder and it plays into the corner. Now it's Gavin McCarthy, the goal scorer. Down low, Harvey at the point. Now it is Lane Hudson at the hash marks, pinching in on the play. Has a pass, blocked, it goes off the glass. Here comes BC the other way. Will Smith sends an awkward pass into the over the glass of TD Garden. How did he do that, guys?
Yeah, he was trying to hit Gabe Perreault just a little bit too high on that one.
I mean, Gabe Perreault would have to been about at least 10 feet taller to get that pass.
Yeah, sadly, he stands at an average height.
Yeah, I really like the addition of Jelvik to this line.
I do too.
Just the addition of that speed. He's been working super hard this entire game. He's always a guy who's a workhorse, and typically he's rewarded for it. I think that needs a spark right now.
Absolutely. 2-1, the score here, 8:13 to go in the second period. Gabe Perreault has it at the Bruins logo. Over for Smith, he sends it in deep. Goes over the pad of Karan. It's at the point. Jelvik keeps it in. On this second line is Oscar Jelvik now with the two freshman phenoms for BC. Quinn Hudson plays it across, trying to find Jack Hughes. Puck was too hard for him to handle. Kept in the zone by Ryan Green. Trying to send it cross-corner dump, but it's taken away by Gustafson, who carries it into the offensive zone for BC on the right-hand side. Shoots it on the backhand, right into the netting. 7:37 to go in the second period. 2-1 is the score.
Gustafson went pretty confidently 1-on-3 against that BU defense. I think that's really good to see.
Absolutely. So 7:37 to go in the second period. 2-1 is the score. We're going to take a two-minute timeout here. We're going to send it back to Liam and Eleanor in the studio. Getting ready to come back here. We'll give you 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hello, you're listening to WZBC Newton 90.3 FM. 7:37 to go in the second period of the Hockey East Championship between the Boston College Eagles and the Boston University Terriers. BU wins the faceoff in their defensive zone. And McCarthy over for Quinn Hudson. Into the Terriers' offensive zone it goes. And a whistle is blown as the puck goes out of play. Now, guys, it seems like no team has really gotten any offensive zone opportunities in these past few minutes. What do you make of that?
I just think both teams have clamped down on defense. And a lot of just dumping the pucks in and changing is what has happened in this past, like, few minutes for both the Eagles and the Terriers. I think that passivity will change once we get into the third period. But who knows? Maybe it'll change in this last 7:21.
Absolutely. Hudson over for his brother, Lane Hudson, at the left point. Over for McCarthy, right point. Misses on purpose. Over for Quinn Hudson, below the goal line. Puck squeaks out to the point. Kept in by Jack Hughes.
Yeah.
Played by a high stick, the referee rules. And we'll have a face-off outside the BU offensive zone. With 7:05 to go in the second period.
That was an impressive feat of just smacking it down. Do high sticks not go down to the other end?
Not sure.
Might be a bad whistle.
I think if the high sticks, wait, are you asking where the puck's placed?
Yeah.
Yeah, if the high sticks in the neutral zone, it goes to your defensive zone. But if you're in the offensive zone, it goes into the neutral zone.
Okay.
So 7:05 to go in the second period for our radio listeners. I'm sorry about that one. As we said, we were going to send it over to Liam and Eleanor in the studio. Seems like they weren't paying attention. Here is Fortescue over for Powell, below the goal line, working the puck out of the BC defensive zone is those two. Mike Posma wins the race, can't win the race to get there. Here's Zabinet over for Wilmer, who has it crossed up at the blue line. But Wilmer gets there in his defensive zone. Lee's looking for an option. Into the neutral zone he goes. Gets it over for Zabinet, who carries it into the offensive zone. Takes a shot. It goes wide. Fowler wasn't ready for it, but it ends up on the stick of Fortescue. He loses it. Peterson. Zabinet shoots. Blocked by Powell in front. A good play by the BC captain out of Marcellus, New York. Sent in deep by BC, and they're going to go for a change. Hudson. Lane Hudson sends it in deep for Stevens, but the referee rules that it was an offsides.
Intentional offsides. This is going to come into the defensive zone for Boston University.
So 2-1 remains the score. 6:11 to go in the second period.
I really like the change of the lines with Cutter Gasso and Ryan Leonard. It's interesting. I think that it's throwing BU off, and that was the goal.
Well, 2-1 is the score, 6:11 to go in the period. McCarthy, the captain of this BU team, plays it off the boards to his D partner, Weber. He plays it off the boards for Tuck, who taps it for Kaplan. Kaplan, back for Tuck, who was the MVP of the Beanpot game against BC just a few weeks ago. Here's Kaplan, has it stripped by Armstrong. Down the left-hand side, plays it across. Ambrosio shoots one off the glove of Caron. Ambrosio really comes through in these big games, guys, but he just can't buy a goal. Malone grinding for the puck at the hash marks. Ambrosio over for Bengston. Gustafson takes a shot, blocked in front by Armstrong, and here comes BU the other way. Luke Tuck, backhand Stevens shoots into the glove of Fowler, who plays it over for Armstrong, who plays it off the boards for his line mate, Jack Malone, who sends it in deep for the Eagles, and that line's going to go for a change. Out pops the first line of Boston College. Ryan Leonard, Andre Gasso, and Cutter Gauthier. Here's Celebrini. Cuts to the middle, shoots. It goes wide. LaChance digging for the puck for BU. At the top of the circle. Can't find his man, Celebrini, and it goes into the neutral zone. Leonard over for Gasso. Right-hand side, Andre Gasso on the backhand, trying to feed Gauthier in front. Would have been called for goaltender interference. Leonard takes a shot. It goes wide. Gavin McCarthy has the puck in the defensive zone over for Macklin Celebrini. And then Harvey plays it off the boards and in for the Terriers. Minetian spun off the puck by Celebrini, but BC wins the puck back. Gauthier past the Bruins logo into the offensive zone. Ryan Leonard fires a shot off the post. Leonard collects the puck again, across, trying to find Perreault. Gauthier has it, loses it. Quinn Hudson now has the puck for BU. Hudson skies it into the offensive zone for BU. Case McCarthy plays it around the boards. And then it's rimmed around and out of the zone by BC. But here comes Jelvik. He's got Smith with him. Jelvik can't dangle past Case McCarthy and Lane Hudson. I'd like to see him pass that puck. Here's Will Smith, carries it into the zone for BC. Across, trying to find Powell. Down low, below the goal line. He moves around the net. For Smith, he shoots one. And it goes wide around for Jelvik. Now it's Perreault. He slings it all the way out of the zone for BC.
I just wanted to point out someone we haven't really talked about enough is Drew Fortescue. I'll get to that in a second.
Here's Jelvik for Perreault, trying to get past Green. But then a diving play by Will Smith gets the puck back for the Eagles. Perreault, backhand for Jelvik. Now it's Smith looking for the hat trick, shoots one. Caron shoulders it away. 2-1 is the score. Bengston knocked out of the play with an injury. Peterson over for Sabine. Safe foul, the rebound in front. Hughes trying to put it in. He can't. Peterson takes a shot. Sabine takes a shot. Blocked by Jelvik. Cleared out of the zone by BC. 3:07 to go in the second period. 2-1 remains the score.
The crowd has erupted. Jacob Fowler with some incredible saves.
Here comes BU in the offensive zone. Zabinet below Wilmer below the goal line. Gustafson trying to take it away from him. Gustafson's been out there for a while. Bengston finally makes it to the bench. Looks like there are four forwards out there for BC right now, guys. Not sure what to make of that. Peterson has it in the offensive zone. A bit of a miscommunication on the BC bench. Here's Wilmer below the goal line. Gauthier finally able to get the puck out of the zone for BC. No icing as a good sky out center was that from Gauthier. Finally though, BC able to get another. BC still rocking with four forwards out there, guys. What can you make of that?
Greg Brown was livid. He was just screaming his butt off, getting up on the bench. Very careless by BC just to let that happen.
How did nobody know that there were four forwards on
the
ice?
We're going to get a penalty on Luke Tuck here. Luke Tuck's going to the box. I did not catch anything.
What a chaotic past few minutes for
both
these teams.
Not sure what that was. I would like, I thought we were going to get a replay.
2:09 to go in the second period. Guys, what did we see in these last few minutes?
Oh, my, great defense by BC, but also carelessness and just Cutter Gauthier taking a defenseman's shift out there. It seems like the fourth line was out there and Cutter just hopped the bench. I'm not quite sure, but just Fowler was standing on top of his head. Bengston got hurt. It was hard to keep track of everything going on, if I'm being honest, Jacob.
Yeah, Greg Brown was absolutely livid on the bench with his team.
Yeah, he actually just yelled at Cutter again. I don't know if you saw that. When they panned in on him, I said, Greg Brown, coach of the year, he grabbed Cutter's helmet and turned his head and said, you can't do that, is what he said. So, yeah, definitely a mistake by Cutter Gauthier on that one.
Yeah, crucial mistake by the Eagles. They're luckily it doesn't bite them. Heroes of that play was Oscar Jelvik blocking that shot.
What I was going to say before was Drew Fortescue has played incredibly well this game. A lot of great poke checks, and in general, just putting his body in the right place at the right time to make sure that players like Luke Tuck and Macklin Celebrini aren't getting easy shots or easy paths to the net.
Yeah, and just the effort level, I think, has taken a huge jump in the last 2-3 minutes. I don't know if that's due to just the injury of Bangston getting curled out there or what else, but Will Smith was diving for pucks. Oscar Jelvik with the best save sequence we've seen all game. It's super impressive just to see the effort levels jump up. And I think that has a huge part to the fans. I mean, they're absolutely roaring.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a cross-check slash boarding on Luke Tuck against Lucas Gustafson way away from the play.
Well, a careless mistake by Luke Tuck and a careless mistake by Cutter Gauthier leads to a power play for the Eagles and an otherwise nothing period for this BC squad. Gabe Perreault, Cutter Gauthier, Ryan Leonard, Eamon Powell, and Will Smith out there on this star-studded BC power play. Ryan Green, Case McCarthy, Cade Weber, and Sam Stevens killing the penalty for BU. Gauthier and Green going at it at the faceoff dot. Referee drops the puck. Gauthier ties up his man on the draw and ends up at the point. Will Smith, left point, moves towards the center, feeds Powell. Now it's back for Smith, top of the left circle. Now it's Powell, high slot, down low. Perreault has all day, shoots, save made by Caron. It ends up in the corner. Stevens trying to get it out for BU, can't get it. Stevens plays it into the BC bench, so we'll have a face-off back in the BC offensive zone with 1:48 to go in the period, 1:39 to go in the penalty box. Assessed to Luke Tuck.
Perhaps one of the most underrated parts about this Hockey East Championship weekend is the really cool Hockey East chains that they're selling as merchandise. I think the ZBC crew might need to get one.
Well, we'll see what happens in the next 21 minutes and 47 seconds of this game, and perhaps more, as BU clears it all the way down. 1:30 to go in Luke Tuck's penalty. 2-1 is the score here at TD Garden. Here's Gauthier, past the Bruins logo, he goes into the offensive zone. Sends it to Smith, who sends it to Leonard, shoots, blocked in front by Sam Stevens and cleared all the way down. Good effort by Sam Stevens to get across and block the shot. Smith drops it for Perreault, back, drops it again for Smith, down low, Perreault in front, scores! Cutter Gauthier, 3-1 Eagles, 1:14 to go in this Battle of ComEv, final matchup between the Eagles and the Terriers in the second period.
Crowd is rocking, go Eagles, wow, the crowd erupted, yeah. Great pass by Gabe Perreault to see Cutter across the crease. And like I said before the game, this is how you get Matthew Caron. Matthew Caron, when out of position, cannot recover.
Third power play goal this game. Eagles are on fire on the power play. I think they haven't missed yet.
What a tremendous goal from Cutter Gauthier as he sprints across the ice and buries it for Boston College to give them the 3-1 advantage over Boston University. So something was thrown on the ice. Brendan, did you catch what it was?
It was trash. Let's hope it's not from BC fans, because that's how it works. If you're wearing a BC jersey, we're gonna get a bench minor for that. So let's not have that happen.
All right, well, Arimanetians rims it all the way down for BC after they score on the power play, 3-1. Is the score of this game. Manetian at the point, sends it in deep for Gasso. Pressured off the puck by Hudson, sent in deep, Jelvik has it at the hash marks. Dangles past Celebrini, Jelvik still with the puck on his stick, finds Gasso, rims it for Manetian, goes over his stick and all the way down. 44 seconds to go in the second period. Hershuk has the puck for BC, plays it off the boards for Jelvik. Over for Malone, left-hand side. Malone, up top, Hershuk, left point. Over for Manetian. Now it is Yelvi at the hash marks. To the left of Karan. Over for Malone. Loses the puck. He's wrapped up. 20 seconds to go in the period. Celebrini over for Lachance. Now it is Celebrini again. Past the Bruins logo, down the middle of the ice, he goes into the offensive zone. He still has the puck on his stick. He's going to go for a change. 8 seconds to go in the period. 3-1 is the score in favor of Boston College. And 2-1. And that'll do it for period two here on WZBC Newton. Guys, before we go to our 15-minute break, I need to hear your thoughts. How was that period for both these teams?
I think at the start, it was definitely a BU-dominated period, but BC really came out strong in these last six-ish minutes. A lot of physicality, a lot of power, and a goal.
I think penalties have been the deciding factor this game. BC just has dominated the special teams battle, electric penalty kills, and was able to completely just work BU on the power play. Beautiful pass by Gabe Perreault. That's about it, Jacob.
Yeah, well, that'll do it for the second period here from TD Garden. We'll be back in 15 minutes here on WZBC Newton. Again, my name is Jacob Lassner, joined alongside by Reynolds Johnson and Brendan Mahoney. We'll be back in 15 short minutes to broadcast the third period here live from TD Garden. We're going to send it back to Liam and Eleanor in the studio for 15 brief minutes. getting ready to come back here. We'll give you 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hello and welcome to WZBC Newton for tonight's coverage of the Hockey East Championship. Here live from TD Garden between the Boston College Eagles and the Boston University Terriers. As the teams take the ice now with 1 minute to go until this third period. Guys, what are the keys for both these teams to kind of get moving? And I don't know, for the BU Terriers, Reynolds, what do they have to do to claw back into this game?
If I'm BU, the number one thing I want to do is draw a penalty. That's something Macklin Celebrini has been so good at this year. If you can get your penalty kill back on the ice and just claw back within one goal, I think that's where you want to be if you're a Terrier.
Absolutely.
Yeah, for BC, on the other hand, I think just continue what they're doing to end the second period.
Yeah, I would agree with that, Reynolds. Who do you think is the X factor for Boston College besides Jacob Fowler in this period?
Like you said, it's hard not to say Jacob Fowler since he's been just rock solid. But I'm gonna have to go with Will Smith. I mean, he just broke the freshman scoring record at BC. He could be on natural Hattie watch. He's just been phenomenal today. And he's had some really good effort plays, especially at the end of the second period. If those can translate to offense, I'd expect him to score again.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think Will Smith's played really well, looking for that hat trick. I think BC just needs to lock it down here and make sure they don't do anything stupid.
Absolutely, guys. Well, faceoff has dropped here in this third period, live from TD Garden. Lane Hudson has the puck in the neutral zone for Boston University. He sends it all the way in to the offensive zone, takes an awkward bounce off the glass, and Minetian clears it out over for Gauthier into the neutral zone. He goes down the right-hand side into the offensive zone. He takes a shot, ramps wide of the net. Gasso sends it back in for Cutter Gauthier. Over for Jelvik, blocked in front by Hudson. Now it's Harvey. Over for his line mate, Celebrini, trying to make a pass across for Wilmer, or for LeChance, but it was blocked by Minetian and sent all the way down. Celebrini sends it back into this defensive zone for Lane Hudson. Hudson stops up behind his own net for a minute, and he looks up. Hudson, with his head up, enters the neutral zone for BU. Curls back into his defensive zone, tries to feed a pass right through the middle, ends up with Will Smith, who chops it back for Powell, gives it to Fortescue. Perreault sends it in deep for the Eagles. Ryan Leonard trying to get there first for BC. He takes it away from Weber, but Green takes it away from him. Green, with a lot of speed through the neutral zone, he goes. Ryan Green into the offensive zone. Drops it, Hughes, trying to look for a pass, can't find anyone. Will Smith going the other way, over for Perreault. He plays it off the boards and in deep for the Eagles. Perreault in the corner. Cade Weber is there. He takes it away for the Terriers, tries to send it out. Gustafson, though, collects it and sends it back in for the Eagles from the neutral zone. 18:29 to go in the third period. You're listening to WZBC Newton, 90.3 FM. Here's Willander. Backhands a shot, just hits the edge of the glass, stays in play. Zabinet backhands it back in for the Terriers. Gustafson on the puck. Gustafson over for Armstrong. It just trickles out over the stick of Gavin McCarthy, the goal scorer for BU. Zabinet in the neutral zone, pulling off some nifty moves, sends it in deep for the Terriers. Now it is Bengston. Over for Gustafson, around the goal. Bengston skies it for Armstrong. Sent all the way down, no icing on the play. McCarthy over for Lane Hudson. Now it is Wilmer at the blue line, who sends it into the neutral zone for Peterson, who taps it back for Lane Hudson, the puck carrier for this BU Terrier offense. Lane Hudson stops up at the point, dangles past Armstrong, goes towards the hash marks, throws it in front. It's in front. Fowler trying to cover it up. BU really hacking at Fowler here. They dig it deep, and Peterson checks his own man into the ground. Sam Stevens is really slow to get up here, guys.
Yeah, I would be really shocked if Jack Malone doesn't get a penalty for this. Jack Malone actually threw Sam Stevens to the ground. I'm sure Sam Stevens deserved it, but yeah.
That was pretty vicious. They're showing the replay up right now. Just kind of goes around. I understand where they're coming from, hacking at the goalie. Oh, that's not that bad. Yeah, it looks like he hit his head on the breezers of his
own
player.
Jack Malone's going to get a penalty. Figured that would happen.
So Jack Malone heads to the box. The lethal Boston University power play takes the ice with 17:33 to go in the third period. Jack Malone to the box for Boston College. Shane LaChance taking the draw against Mike Posma. Again, Jack Malone taking his second penalty of the night, something you don't see from the veteran. BC wins the faceoff. Hershuck trying to send it out of the zone. He does. It goes over the stick of Hudson and into the offensive zone for BC, which means Hudson will have to work it out himself. Lane Hudson goes past Gasso, sends it back for Ryan Green, over for Celebrini. In the offensive zone, Macklin Celebrini, Gauthier lays a big shoulder into him. Now it's Quinn Hudson at the point. Moving, top of the circle, shoots one. It just goes wide. Macklin Celebrini has it at the hash mark. Sends it across. Quinn Hudson has a lane. Minetti trying to block it. It just goes wide. Macklin Celebrini over for Lane Hudson at the top of the slot, or the high slot. Down low, Quinn Hudson. Faceoff dot, shoots one. Save Fowler. Now it is LaChance. He's taken away, and Minetti sends it all the way down for BC.
Yeah, Cutter is marking Macklin Celebrini really hard. He's in Celebrini's grill every single second. He was super rattled and couldn't get any good shots off.
Well, here comes Lane Hudson back into the offensive zone. 1 minute to go on the kill for the Eagles. LaChance at the hash marks to the right of Jacob Fowler, sends it in deep for Ryan Green. Now it is Quinn Hudson at the top of the circle, across, Celebrini shoots, save Fowler. Rebound is collected by Leonard. Leonard and Armstrong on a 2-on-3 rush. Leonard trying to dangle past Hudson. He does! Throws one on net. Good save there, though, by Caron. Shots on goal for both these teams. 23 in favor of Boston University and 19 for BC. Luke Tuck has it taken away, and Armstrong sends it all the way down. Oscar Jelvik and Will Smith now killing the penalty for BC. 20 seconds to go in the kill. Wilmer has it on his stick in the defensive zone for BU. Sends it back for Hughes, past the Bruins logo. The Northeastern transfer, trying to dangle past Minetti. Can't do it. Rims it around for Kaplan, who rims it back around for Hughes. 4 seconds to go in the kill. Hughes, up top, Willander, back down low. Hughes, across, Wilmer, top of the circle, shoots one into the glove of Fowler with 15:27 to go in the third period.
Yeah, great kill overall. I think we had a lot of really good possession and also just a few nice tosses down the ice.
Like you mentioned, Cutter just absolutely marked Celebrini, their best power play. I mean, he's running the power play when he's out there. If you can just mark him and take him off, Cutter had a very like heavy shift over towards him, making it almost like a 4-on-3. And I really think that's awesome.
Absolutely. Second line out there for BC. Cutter Gauthier, Andre Gasso, and Oscar Jelvik. Or actually, my apologies, Gabe Perreault is out there playing left wing.
Interesting.
Trying to give Jack Malone a shift off after the unfortunate penalty taken by the veteran forward. BC, though, has iced the puck. So faceoff will go right back where it started with 15:20 to go in the third period.
I really like switching the lines. I think it's keeping the BU defenders on their toes. You know, no one has really seen what it looks like to have Cutter Gauthier and Gabe Perreault out there 5-on-5. That's something that we really haven't seen at all this season, so it's really interesting.
Yeah, I bet going into the national tournament, Greg Brown is trying to figure out what his best chance of winning is, as a shot was taken by Zabinet, blocked by Gauthier, and Gasso's trying to get it out, but Gavin McCarthy keeps it in for the Terriers, over for Zabinet, down low Peterson, below the goal line. Spins off a hit from Gasso, trying to feed Gavin McCarthy, taken away by Perreault. Over for Gauthier, back down low for Gasso into the offensive zone. Gauthier, top of the circle, takes a shot, it goes wide. Maybe that was missed on purpose. Gabe Perreault has it around the point. He cross corner, sends it in for Fortescue. Stick on the ice belongs to Gavin McCarthy. Powell rims it back around for BC. Colby Ambrosio trying to get there first. But BU is going to be able to get it out of their zone. Gavin McCarthy is going to regroup. Macklin Celebrini hops out on the ice for the Terriers. They need a jump here, and I think that Macklin Celebrini is the guy that they're looking to provide it. Sent all the way in by BU, but BC trying to clear it out of their zone. Jack Malone has it taken away. Jack Harvey plays it offsides for this Terrier team with 14:19 to go in the third period. The score is 3-1 in favor of Boston College.
Yeah, I think that the BU band's trying to revive some spirits in the BU student section, which has gone a little bit silent at the beginning of this third period. They're not out of this by any means, you know? This
Absolutely.
Boston University offense is incredible, so let's you know, stay cautious for these last 14 minutes.
Absolutely. 3-1 is the score. 14-19 to go in the third period. Hudson has it into the offensive zone for BU. Hershuk over for Jelvik into the neutral zone. Left-hand side sends it in deep for the Eagles. Macklin Celebrini first on the puck, rims it around for the chance. Andre Gasso digging for the puck for BC. Him, Gauthier, and Jelvik on the ice for the Eagles. Hershuk sends it in deep. Taken away, though, by Willander, and he takes a fall to the ice. The ice is indeed slippery. Errant pass goes through the legs of Hudson and into the neutral zone. Ryan Leonard, Gabe Perreault, and Will Smith out there now. Leonard carries it in for BC. Leonard trying to force his way in front. Pucks in front. Will Smith trying to go for the Hattie into the glove of Caron.
What a save, Matthew Caron. Falling backwards onto his bum. Big grab there.
Tremendous
save. I want to see the replay on that, yeah.
Wow. As we look at the replay here in our
phenomenal
beautiful
save, Matthew Caron.
Yeah, as we look at the replay here at our beautiful booth in TD Garden, we thank all the people at TD Garden for allowing us to broadcast this game, as well as the people at WZBC Newton, including Andrew Guarino and Saren Juan, for letting us broadcast this game. And for you, our loyal listeners, thank you for all of your support that you've shown throughout this season. So, 13:28 to go in the third period. Reynolds, what have you noticed so far from both these teams in this period?
I think there's been a lot. Both teams have been able to establish an offensive presence, maybe BC a bit more than BU, but definitely less transition than the second period. I'm excited to see where this is going to go. I mean, you got 13 minutes left. It's really crunch time for BU. Also, I mean, I'm excited to see when they're going to pull the goalie, if they need to come to that. I don't know if BU is a team that's pretty eager to do it, but if it were me, I'd do it around the six-minute mark. Just try to establish any offense you can, especially against this DC defense, which has been really locked down tonight.
Yeah, I would agree with that, Reynolds. I'm not sure how soon former NHL and Terrier player Jay Pandolfo, Boston University class of 1996. This is his second season coaching the Terriers.
He's an Islanders legend, right, Jacob? Your favorite NHL team.
Absolutely. I love Jay. I remember watching it as a youngin' playing for the New York Islanders. They're not having the greatest season in the world right now. Eagles, certainly, the team that I am most behind right now.
I'm lucky my Bruins are having a good season, too, but who knows? Bruins tend to choke that.
Absolutely. 3-1's the score. 13:28 to go in the third period. Will Smith, Ryan Leonard, Gabe Perreault out there for BC. Case McCarthy trying to clear the zone for BU. It ends up on the stick of Leonard, who tried to bank it in off Caron. Can't do it. Leonard makes a nice move. Pass to BC player. And he passes it to Smith. Hat-trick! Hat-trick for Will Smith! Hat-trick for Will Smith! 13:30 to go into third period. 3-1 is the score.
Where are the hats? Only one's made it to the ice, but beautiful, able to bank it in. Ryan Leonard, the hero in the moves there. Oh, my God.
Oh, Sam Stevens throws a hat. He's very sad with this result. Oh, yeah, the hats come on. Hat trick for Will Smith.
Get a picture of that, Brendan. Yep. Oh, my goodness.
Going right on the Twitter. For all our listeners, check the Twitter at WZBC Sports.
Wow. 13:14 to go. The Eagles take a 4-1 lead here at TD Garden. My goodness, what a turn of events. The freshman line comes through. Ryan Leonard moves past two BU defenders and sends a beautiful pass over to his friend Will Smith, who tucks it in for the Eagles. That's his hat trick goal here at TD Garden. Unbelievable turn of events for the Eagles.
Just love to see it, truly amazing.
Well, if you're the Terriers, how do you respond now? I mean, you're down three goals. This is really rough territory.
Wow. No words for that one, guys. Hat trick for Will Smith. Hat trick for Will Smith. My goodness. 13:14 to go in the third period. 4-1 is now the score.
Wow. Just a surreal feeling. Wow.
So, Civ chant starting up here in TD Garden. Sounds like Conti Forum at this present moment. Tuck has the puck for BU. He takes a shot. Puts it on the rebound at the top of the faceoff dot. Trying to send it across. Kaplan keeps it in for BU. As that was the Civ champ. Familiar to BC fans. And Jack Malone with a big hit on Gavin McCarthy. Here's Fortescue. He plays it off the boards. Kept in the zone by Stevens. He sends it back for Kaplan. Malone on the puck now. He goes past the blue line into the neutral zone. Here comes Kaplan. He shoots one. Ramped off the stick of Fortescue and out of the zone. 12-12 to go in the third period. 4-1 is the score. You're listening to WZBC Newton.
That was a massive hit on Gavin McCarthy right there. And the ref kind of helped him. He got pushed into the ref, so the ref just kind of gave one arm and threw him down on the ice, helping out BC a bit right there. Typically not the case, but you know, love to see the refs helping BC out a bit.
Yeah, I at a loss for words. This is a surreal feeling. We're not done yet, but we're getting there.
Absolutely, Brendan. So, that was Will Smith's first career collegiate hat trick, everyone. 12:04 to go in the third period. 4-1 is the score. Boston College Eagles have a commanding three-goal lead with 11:58 to go in the third period.
Nick Zabin is very hurt and stumbles over to the bench. He looks very badly hurt. I think it was knee-to-knee contact.
Oh, my goodness. Well, was that a penalty on BC, Brendan?
I don't think so.
Well,
no, I don't think so. I think it was the icing. Yeah.
In any case, 11:54 to go in the third period here. BC is still up 4-1 over the BU Terriers. Boston University has it in their defensive zone. Here, they pass it out to Case McCarthy. Into the offensive zone he goes. He sends it in deep. Aaron Minetian on the backhand, trying to clear it out, but he lost it. Shot on goal. Grabbed by Fowler as he makes a catcher's-like grab as it kind of handcuffs him there, guys. Maybe a changeup.
Yeah, Fowler's played outstanding tonight outside of that one goal, which was the laser. Give Gavin McCarthy credit on that one. But, yeah, Fowler's played really well.
So, face-off. As we see some rowdy BC fans pouring alcohol on each other on the video board. Here's Minetian in his own zone. Plays it off the boards for Gasso. Gasso, past the Bruins logo, to the left side. He sends it in deep for the Eagles. He gets there first. Over for Jelvik around the boards. Now it's Minetian at the point, and he takes a shot. Gauthier tips it over the glass and out of play with 11:20 to go in the third period.
Stinks that comes out of the zone because of this. Actually, yeah, it does come out of the zone. It goes into the neutral zone.
Absolutely. So faceoff comes out of the zone for Boston College, an unfortunate turn of events in a game that's been going the Eagles' way for most of the time.
Looks like Zabin is okay. He just took a shift right there, but that was, he was looking pretty shaken up after that hit.
So 11:19 to go in the third period. BC up 4-1. Here's Hershaw right behind Fowler. He's going to stop up for a second and look for an option. Hershaw with his head up in the BC defensive zone sends it over for Gasso. Gasso trying to send it across to Minetian, taken away by Celebrini, but no, Gasso gets there. Down the right-hand side into the offensive zone. He loses the puck. Celebrini going the other way. Left-hand side for Boston University. Drops it for Lachance, who sends it in deep for the Terriers. Celebrini trying to get the puck back for BU. He can't do it. Sent out of the zone and through the legs of McCarthy, Gavin McCarthy. Here's Gauthier, breakaway, chance! Save made by Caron.
Wow.
As Gauthier wasn't really able to muster a lot on that shot, guys.
Yeah, the Eagles are going for blood now. They're not giving up, and I love it. And I think that, you know, three goals is three goals, but at the same time, you know, if anyone can come back down three goals, it's a BU team, so keep it up.
Absolutely. Full pressure has to be the motto for this BC team with 10:36 to go in the game. If the score remains the same. Smith wins the faceoff back for Perreault, for Powell. Now it's Fortescue, plays it off the boards for Perreault. Perreault works his way down low. Puck taken away by Jack Hughes. Skate to stick transition. Fortescue takes away from him, plays it off the glass, and in deep. Caron comes out of his net to get it. Caron rims it around the boards for Jack Hughes. Over for Ryan Green. Into the offensive zone for BU. Green trying to send it across. Powell blocks it, doesn't know where the puck is. Pops out, Case McCarthy, shot, Quinn Hudson, rebound, and it's in front. What a save! What a save! Fowler reaches across with the blocker and keeps it out for the Eagles. My goodness! But here's Jack Hughes at the point, over for McCarthy. Down low for Green. High slot shoots, another save, Fowler, rebound in front. Fortescue knocks his man down, Quinn Hudson. And then Leonard knocks his man down, Ryan Green. Now it's Perreault, one-on-two rush for the Eagles. Trying to get past two players. Gabe Perreault has it in the corner. Taken away by Boston University. Played back for Gabe Perreault. Gabe Perreault with eyes on the back of his head feeds Gustafson, who tries to feed it to Malone in front. Can't find him. Ryan Green has it for Boston University. Over for Hughes. That save.
Still can't get over that incredible save by Jacob Fowler.
My
God. Diving across the net, across his own crease.
Wow.
Just an incredible
goal. He had a wide open net to put the puck in, Quinn Hughes. But Fowler somehow reached the blocker over. He had no stick in his hand. He dropped his stick. Who does that remind you of, guys?
I don't know who you're trying to get at, Jacob.
Dominic Hasek.
Yeah, see, I would not have gotten that.
If you spent hours of your childhood watching Dominic Hasek highlights when you thought you wanted to be a goalie. That one was for you. Here's Gustafson in the BC off defensive zone over for Ambrosio. He's got a lot of speed. He breaks past BU defense and throws it in front. Draws a penalty for BC. What a play by Colby Ambrosio with 8:41 to go in the third period.
Oh, Colby wants the smoke. Devin Kaplan. Oh. Now we have Luke Tuck coming over.
Well,
yeah, BU's looking for any spark they can possibly get, even if it's violence. Oh, Lane Hudson's going to the box.
Yeah,
was it Lane who tripped him?
Yeah, it was Lane Hudson in the box. He will sit in the box for 2 minutes here on WZBC Newton as we see that tremendous save from Jacob Fowler. He drops his stick, pushes from left to right, and gets his blocker on it. My goodness. I've watched that a million times over. Wow.
Make it 2 million. Stamp it. I'll watch it 2 million times.
Again, that was a great job by Colby Ambrosio. Such great bursts of speed from him sometimes. You're not expecting it from a guy who's been on the third and fourth lines for BC this entire year, but he's so quick when he needs to be. He's able to get that bump up, take it to the side, and draw that penalty as he's just trying to cut in against Caron.
My goodness. What a turn of events this has been.
I still feel uneasy just because, you know, I'm not going to feel good until the final buzzer sounds, but we're getting there. 8:41 to go in this third period as we're going to have a BC power play for 2 minutes of that.
BC fans are on their feet here at TD Garden.
I will say, sad BU fans ranks among my top things in this world. Wow, that save is incredible. Really, really just amazing.
That's definitely going to be up. That's a highlight reel right there. The Canadiens prospect, I mean, if you're a Canadiens fan, you're, oh my God. I mean, this game has just been a feast for you. Lane Hudson's played great. Boneheaded penalty right there, but besides that, awesome. Fowler, too.
Absolutely. So, face-off, missed drop by the referee, was won by Boston University. Doesn't really matter. Interesting thing to note here, Case McCarthy taking the face-off for Boston University. What can you make of that, guys? He's normally a defenseman.
Interesting. I guess just age, that's what they're going for right now.
Well, Perreault sends it across for Leonard as he wins the face-off against the defenseman. Here's Leonard. He's got a few people open. Perreault trying to feed it in front. It's Gauthier. Perreault scores! 5-1. Make it 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 goals for the Eagles tonight. 8:28 to go in the third period. My goodness.
Wow. We are rocking. This place is rocking. And we're going to be rocking our way to the number one seed in the NCAA tournament and a Hockey East Championship.
Gabe Perreault had the biggest smile on his face. God, it's got to feel good. I mean, coming back from injury, 3 weeks of injuries, you know, you kind of lose your stake in the Hobie Baker race, and you prove you should have been in it today. I mean, one goal, two goals yesterday, and just great hand-eye coordination to bat that in.
Gabe Perreault makes no mistake, bats out a rebound from midair as Gauthier also does his best to stuff it in. There was no goaltender in the BU net there.
Is that four power play goals for the Eagles? I mean, that's just incredible. That's so scary. I don't think they missed once this entire game. That's so impressive.
Unbelievable turn of events for the Boston College Eagles. 5-1 is the score. Oscar Jelvik has it, sends it in deep for the Eagles. 8:23 to go in the third period. Here's Hudson across. Gavin McCarthy off the boards. Four. Hughes, who rims it in deep. Off the stanchion, awkward bounce. Gauthier collects for the Eagles. Into the neutral zone, over for Jelvik. Past the blue line, drops it back. Gauthier at the hash mark, sends it in deep for the Eagles. Oscar Jelvik trying to get there. It ends up, Gauthier at the slot, blocked by Hudson in front. As we get to hear another Civ chant here in TD Garden. Jack Malone has it in the neutral zone. He sends it in deep for the Eagles. Macklin Celebrini collects for Boston University. Sends it forward, met by a big hit from Armstrong and the referee. Oh my goodness. And another, wow. Gavin McCarthy comes over and just cross-checks the midsection of Jamie Armstrong. No penalty on that play, but regardless, Boston University heads to the power play.
Yeah, good call. Jamie Armstrong was not gonna get away with that one. Kind of just a brutal physical play. Actually, in slow-mo, it does not look as bad as it looked live.
Well, you know, this league, they have to kind of protect a guy like Macklin Celebrini when a guy comes at him full speed like that. Could have been ruled a charging penalty.
And he didn't get full contact either. I think it's because he skimmed him. Kind of ended up tripping him on the play at full speed. It looks, the contact looks a lot more dangerous than it is in reality. But if he got him square on, would have been a bit of a better hit. But I also think it's a good call by the refs. I mean, your BC's up 5-1. I think it's good. You're giving Boston University a chance to come back here.
So 7:33 to go in the third period. The Terriers go to the kill. Looks like they've called a timeout.
Brendan, who's been your player of the game for the Eagles tonight?
They're challenging for a 5-minute major. That's embarrassing. We're going to see about that one. I don't think this is a major. I really don't.
Well, let's see. It all depends on if Armstrong leaves his feet to make the check, and he does, but also at the same time, that could be due to him losing his balance in the end of the day.
Yeah, that's just two for tripping.
Yeah, I would agree.
Well, like I was saying, Brendan, who's been your player of the game today?
Player of the game, I'm gonna say Will Smith. I think I have to. Will Smith played absolutely phenomenal today. I wonder who's going to end up getting MVP of the tournament for BC, as we'll see that in the, you know, coming 20-ish minutes following the trophy presentation, the presentation of the Hockey East Tournament MVP. I think Smith's got a pretty good shot at that. I don't know. We'll see. But, you know, barring a crazy...
I would vote for Will Smith at this present moment, or Jacob Fowler.
I actually believe we can vote. I just don't know how. But well, I'll figure that out in the next few minutes. Barring a crazy four-goal comeback from BU in the next 7.5 minutes, this will be the first time since 2012 that BC has won the Hockey East Championship. You know, it's a pretty special feeling. We're not there yet, but we're very much on our way. Refs are still talking. Let's see. I'm trying to catch if I can see what they're saying.
I think I said
wow,
and they have
major.
Ruled a 5-minute major, folks. So Boston University will go to the power play for 5 straight minutes with 7:33 to go in the third period. You got to look to what Jay Pandelfo does, Reynolds, as you were saying earlier, in regards to pulling Matthew Caron. That will become a big storyline heading into the last 5 minutes of this game.
Yeah, and non-releasable, even more so. You got the next until 2 minutes, 2 minute 30 second mark, PU's going to be on the power play here. I'm surprised if they don't go for six.
So, huge opportunity for the BU Terriers. Hudson for Celebrini, blocked by Leonard with his shoulder. He's laboring a little bit. Here's Hudson, Quinn Hudson, top of the circle. Over for Celebrini. For Lane Hudson, puck goes under his stick. Jack Malone chasing. Ryan Leonard goes to the bench for a change. He seems to be all right, but he's going to take a minute for himself. Celebrini takes a shot. Save Fowler with 7:12 to go in the third period. My goodness, guys.
So they just announced penalty is contact to the head.
What?
Yeah.
Didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah, that's the 5 minute. That's kind of crazy.
Interesting. Well, 7:12 to go regardless. 4:40 to go on the kill for the Boston College Eagles. Bit of a different circumstance for this Eagles team, killing off another 5 minute major. Second one in two nights. Green sends it down low for Quinn Hudson. Green still digging for the puck. Jakob Bengtsson trying to force him off. LeChance rims it around for Celebrini. It goes through the stick of Hudson once again. Here comes Will Smith one-on-one against Hudson. Smith against his former teammate in the World Juniors, Lane Hudson. I'm sure they're good friends off the ice. Here's Macklin Celebrini into the neutral zone. He's carrying the puck. 6:40 to go in the third period. 4 minutes to go on this power play for the BU Terriers. 1 minute gone on the kill. Here's Green. Up top, Lane Hudson dangles past Gasso. Cuts to the middle for Celebrini. Shoots one. It goes wide. And a race for the puck. Gasso gets there first. One-on-one against Hudson. Gasso trying to force his way to the front. Tries to get through the net of Caron, but Caron steps in the way. Now, here's BU. So, BU has the puck in their defensive zone. Willander over for Jack Hughes. He rims it into the offensive zone for Boston University. It goes into the netting and out of play. 6:01 to go in the third period. 3:28 to go on the kill.
Yeah, something I find kind of interesting, this happened tonight and last night, is 5 minute majors without game misconducts. Usually in the Hockey East, it's almost inevitable that you get game misconduct with a major, but we had a major on Posma last night and a major on Armstrong, and neither of those resulted in game misconducts. Not sure if that's a playoff thing or just discretion, but...
Well, in any case, Boston University on the power play. 3 minutes and 28 seconds. 5-1 is the score in favor of the Eagles. Leonard over for Hershuck. He pins it against the boards. He's met by a big hit from Kaplan. That could be contact to the head, guys. And Gauthier clears it all the way down for the Eagles. Caron comes out of his net to play it. He rims it around for Wilmer in his own zone. Over for Hughes. 5:41 to go in the period. 3:07 to go in the kill. Wilmer across, Ryan Green, past the Bruins logo, sends it in deep for the Eagles. Cutter Gauthier trying to get the puck for BC. Luke Tuck goes another hit on Charlie Letty, ends up in the stick of Kaplan. His shot from the point, save Fowler, Tuck digging for the rebound, and Eamon Powell pushes him away, and then Fowler throws the stick at Luke Tuck.
Important to note that Eamon Powell and Luke Tuck are very close friends. They grew up about 12 minutes down the road from one another. The Powells and the Tucks trained together in the summer, so a little bit of a testy relationship between good friends. Oh, wow, yeah, they are very good friends, the Tucks and the Powells.
Yeah, well, when your friend puts his stick under the mask of your goalie's your best friend over your best friend. 5:22 to go in the third period. 2:50 to go on the power play for Boston University. A major penalty called on Jamie Armstrong for contact to the head. Hudson. Across, Celebrini shoots, he scores! You couldn't keep him silent for that long, Boston College. 5-2 is the score, 5:15 to go in the third period.
Now they got something, and that's enough to keep him rolling for the rest of the game. Jacob Fowler, done with his water, needs a bit more, throws at the bench, but Macklin Celebrini with a bullet of a shot, that's been missing the entire game. He's been held pretty much silent. I mean, he's made a few good moves here and there, a few good opportunities, but mostly limited to the outside.
So, Macklin Celebrini makes the score 5-2 in favor of the Eagles. 5:15 to go in the third period. Is an impending collapse coming the Eagles' way? We'll find out in the next 5 minutes.
Don't jinx us, Jacob. Please.
Lane Hudson into the offensive zone. Carries it on the forehand. Knocked away by Manetti. Still on the power play is this Terriers team. up top for Macklin Celebrini across Quinn Hudson, shoots one. Bankston blocks it. It's in his equipment, drops down. Quinn Hudson trying to find it. Bankston comes up with the puck and sends it out of the zone and into the BC bench. So faceoff will come outside the defensive zone of Boston College. 5-2 is the score. 4:52 to go in the third period. 2:19 to go in the kill for the Eagles. Brendan, if you're the Eagles right now, what is your message to this team?
Relax, relax. Everyone's looking a little jittery. We're still up 3 goals. Relax, just focus for these last 2:19. I'm curious to see if they pull Karan. I honestly would for a little bit of this.
Well, we'll see what happens. 4:52 to go in the game. 2:19 to go in the period. Eagles win the faceoff. Powell clears it out of the zone. Second power play unit out there for the Terriers. Devin Kaplan at the hash marks, plays it up top. Willander, Hughes, left point, back for Willander, center point, shoots. It's blocked in front, it's in the pads of Fowler, and he is able to hold on with 4:33 to go in the game. 2 minutes to go on the power play now, so they'll have just one normal power play to kill off. But if BU scores, that 2 minutes remains on the clock.
I'm interested to see. I'm watching Karan right now, watching the coaches too, see if they're making any motion towards him.
Yeah, Reynolds, be sure to keep on top of that for us. Here's Hudson at the point, moves towards the center. Down low, Celebrini below the circle, feeds it in front for the chance. It just hops over the net. It goes back to the point. Lane Hudson, left point, moves his way down to the top of the circle. Now he's at the hash marks up top. Celebrini back for Hudson, left point. Moving in, closer towards Fowler. Over to Celebrini, shoots, blocked in front by Hershock, who has no stick. Malone gives Hershock his stick. Malone can't pick up his stick. Into the pad of Fowler. And then it's played back into Fowler by BC. My goodness. What a turn of events for this Eagles team.
Yeah, Ryan Green with a really smart play. Actually just kicking with full force Aiden Hershock's stick way away from him.
Wow. So 4 minutes to go in the game. 1:28 to go on the kill. 5-2 is the score in favor of Boston College. You're listening to WZBC Newton as we're approaching the top of the hour here in Chestnut Hill and beyond. Specifically TD Garden here, folks. Cutter Gauthier sets to take the draw against Green. He wins it back for Powell, who sends it all the way off the boards and out of the zone. Lane Hudson forced to retreat back into his own zone to get the puck. BU bench all standing here and leaning over the boards. They are eager in anticipation to see what happens in the final minute and 11 of this power play. Celebrini weaves his way through a few BC players, and then Ryan Green flubs a pass, leading for Fortescue to get the puck back for BC. And now it's Gauthier over for Smith, one-on-one with Hudson. Hudson takes it away, Lane Hudson specifically. 56 seconds to go in the kill for the Eagles. 3:25 to go in the game.
Karan's going to the bench.
Karan is inching his way towards the bench here for the Terriers. Here's Green into the offensive zone. Rims it around. Karan goes to the bench. Empty net, 6 skaters on the ice for Boston University. It's crunch time for these Terriers. Green in front. Tuck flips it. Celebrini shoots. Rebound. Fowler can't grab it. Cleared out of the zone by BC. 3:03 to go in the game. 29 seconds to go on the power play, assist to Armstrong.
Yeah, big stand there for the Eagles.
And Gasso clears it all the way down, and it just misses. 20 seconds to go on the kill. 5-2 is the score. 2:50 to go in the third period. Will Smith's hat trick, the story of the game so far. Hudson across, Celebrini past the Bruins logo. Now it's Wilmer into the offensive zone, trying to weave his way past Hershock. 5 seconds to go on the kill. Here's Hughes, down low, Tuck. Back for Hughes at the point. Top of the circle he goes. Takes a shot blocked by Gasso. It sits. Hershock. Minetian trying to clear it out. Can't do it. Hughes at the high slot. Harvey keeps it in. Sends it in deep for Tuck. No goalie in net for BU. Wilmer trying to look for a pass. Hershock slides, blocks the pass, and Minetian chops it away. Up top, Harvey. Now it's Willander at the point. Down low for Wilmer. Bottom of the circle. Wilmer moves in, shoots one, save Fowler! With 2:05 to go in the third period. 5-2 remains the score. The Eagles kill off the penalty. Wow.
Oh, I was wondering if we were taking a break or not. I think we're gonna have a longer timeout here.
Yeah, so 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go in this game.
Oh, The students love Mr. Brightside.
Yeah.
That's BC anthem right there. It's BC students. You got some people actually getting out of their seats. BU fans at the bottom in the lower bowl. But I don't know. My star today is Jacob Fowler. 34 shots so far, and he saved 34 shots on goal, saved 32 of them. He's been phenomenal, as well as that sprawling save. I think that save kept BC in the game.
Absolutely. It's a whole different game if that shot goes in. Fowler is an absolute master in net tonight for Boston College.
And then on the other side, I don't even think Karan has played that poorly. It's just BC has just been able to dissect them with passing plays, one-on-ones, just getting in front, getting in the grill, and that's been the key for BC. Maybe, of course, you have that really pretty Will Smith goal, but besides that, they haven't all been gorgeous.
Absolutely, Reynolds. So, 2:05 to go in the third period. 5-2 remains the score here at TD Garden. You're listening to WZBC Newton. That's 90.3 FM or WZBC.org, and press that play button. Ryan Green taking the draw against Cutter Gauthier. 2:05 to go in this Hockey East Championship, people. Green tied up by Gauthier, one forward to Leonard. Pokes it out of the zone for BC. Tremendous play by Ryan Leonard. Will Smith going for his fourth, and it trickles in! Will Smith seals the deal! Boston College 6, Boston University 2. 4 goals for the real Will Smith. My goodness, folks, what a game this has been.
Yeah, that really just settles things right there. 4 goals, two minutes left. It's doable, not by much so, and this is just a great job by the Eagles team. Great job by Will Smith tonight. 4 incredible goals. As able to flip that out from the bench, just trickles in. I mean, diving for it at the end, but just isn't enough for the Terriers.
BU wow. Fans are starting to leave.
And, wow.
And the BC bench is getting really excited.
Yeah.
As they're going to get their second trophy of the season. This one matters a little bit more than the Hockey East regular season one does.
Absolutely, as BC has collected the Hockey East regular season championship, in a minute and 50 seconds, they seek to collect the Hockey East tournament champions. Hockey East postseason action here on WZBC Newton, 1:43 to go in this game. 6-2 is the score in favor of the Boston College Eagles. Fortescue pinned along the board, Sam Stevens over four, Case McCarthy taken away by BC. Stevens knocks his old friend Armstrong off the puck.
Whoa.
Peterson throws Armstrong into the board.
Obnoxious hand, and now Drew Fortescue
can
get a
turn. Man.
Let's not get any penalty. Okay, we don't need this now. We do not need suspensions before the tournament. Let's avoid this. A full-out brawl has broken out. Some players are down on the ice.
Wow.
Wow, Sam Stevens is not a part of it. That's surprising.
That's very surprising. Well, Peterson has forced his way into the box by the referee, Bignazzi.
Obnoxious penalty. Really just embarrassing for Boston University as Drew Fortescue, I think, has been ejected.
Well,
yeah, stick taps for Drew. Drew's going to head to the locker room, but he'll come right back out.
My goodness, Drew Fortescue has been kicked out of this game, but he's been a spark plug for this Eagles team. Zabinet.
Nick Zabinet has also been ejected.
My goodness.
Wow.
Gavin McCarthy put, I think it was Fortescue, in a headlock as I'm looking at the pictures I just took now. That was crazy, guys.
As we're going to have matching fives that'll be just probably fully nullified in just a 2 minute for these Eagles.
Yeah, Fortescue's just sitting right there in the hallway, peering out. I mean, not much he can, he's already got, I mean, he's just gonna get out there.
What's up?
Kind of reminiscent of USA winning the World Championship. You see all the players come out just with their jerseys on. Aaron Minetti in among those.
Absolutely, I remember that one.
Oh, actually, a positive thing I just remembered is, in all likelihood, there will be no suspension for any of these, mostly because Hockey East usually determines suspension for in Hockey East games, and I would doubt that they elevate to this to the NCAA for a suspension. I just don't see that happening. But well, that was just a thought that went through my mind.
Yeah, Greg Brown's really got to tell his Eagles, calm down, as you were saying before, Brendan. 1:24 left in this game. 6-2 is the score between the Eagles and the Terriers.
Right, you're a minute and 24 seconds away from an automatic bid. Number one team in the Hockey East, in the country, perhaps the best college hockey team of all time. Chill out. Chill out. That's what I'll say.
Well, it looks like there's a penalty for Dylan Peterson for 5 minutes on the game clock now for Boston University.
Yeah, Peterson has also been tossed, it looks like.
Yeah, I mean, Eagles can't let anything slide. You don't want to risk any suspensions whatsoever. I don't care if you're paying, you know, Lake Superior State. I think that's the number 16 seed, right, after their bid?
No, the 16 seed's going to be Michigan Tech.
Oh, Michigan Tech, right.
Michigan Tech's the team we're going to be playing.
My mistake.
In all likelihood, there's still some games happening right now that determine the results, so this, not sure yet. But, you know, these Eagles are excited. As Drew Fortescue came to the bench, they gave him high fives and fist bumps for defending his teammate, Jamie Armstrong, who got dirty checked. If anyone's getting a suspension, I think it's going to be Dylan Peterson for a really just obnoxious hit, which has no place in hockey. It was just violent more than anything else. BC fans are rocking right now.
Yeah, I mean, just think, I mean, this is the first time the hockey team has been really exceptional for any of these players. I guess the COVID season, BC was number one, unfortunately canceled, but for a lot of freshmen, sophomores, juniors, this is the first time the team's been really, really good.
As I see, an interesting thing to note, Colby Ambrosio spent this break talking with Jacob Fowler. Greg Brown right now screaming at his guys to probably calm down.
Yeah, he's yelling a little bit.
Well, Jack Malone talking with the referee now.
They turned the 5 into a 2 for Peterson. Actually, no, they took it off the board now. Yeah, he's been ejected, and it looks like Hughes will serve the penalty.
So Hughes will serve the penalty for the final minute and 24 of this game, unless BC decides to put another one in the back of the net of Matthew Caron.
Fortescue put his helmet back on. The trainers are like, relaxed, because that could award him another penalty.
It's true.
For a bench minor. Fortescue's trying to put his helmet back, and he's talking back and forth with fans. Let's avoid that.
Craziness going on at the BC bench. Here's Gustafson. Down low for Jelvik. Now it is Bengston. Sends it across for Gustafson. Top of the circle. 1:14 to go until the Eagles get to throw their helmets and sticks and celebrate this Hockey East championship. McCarthy sends it around the boards, and it goes out of play with 1:06 to go in the third period. 6-2 is the score in favor of the Boston College Eagles. And again, you're listening to WZBC Newton 90.3 FM.
Yeah, we see the scratches also in the tunnel. I don't know if you guys can see them from up here, but they look ready to go out and celebrate. They're in the tunnel, down with the team.
Those players are just as important, in my opinion.
Absolutely.
I mean, iron sharpens iron in practice. Each one of those guys is a super competitor. You see Will Traeger, every opportunity he gets, he's busting his bum on the ice.
Yep.
Off the ice, I'm assuming he's doing the same in practice.
That's
how you see a guy like Gentry Schamberger in the A.
Absolutely, guys. Well, here's Gustafson. He works it back into the BC defensive zone, drops it for Bengston. Now it is Jelvik down the left-hand side. Cuts towards the middle, and now back towards the left. He's met by a hit from Luke Tuck. Tuck back for his line mate. Can't clear it out of the zone. Here's Jelvik. Down low, in front. Malone, poked away by Tuck. Now it is Kaplan. It's a zoo out here, folks. Boston University is throwing everything they can at the Eagles here in not such a great way.
Yeah, it's really classless at the end of the day to lose like this, to just violently throw your bodies around.
Yeah, absolutely. Gotta wonder what a matchup with these two teams in the future would look like. Here's McCarthy, Gavin McCarthy. One of the goal scorers for Boston University. 19, 18, 17 seconds to go on the clock. 6-2 remains the score. Jack Harvey with the puck, throws it out on Fowler. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The Eagles win the Hockey's championship. The Eagles win the Hockey's championship. The Eagles win the Hockey's championship. 6-2, the Battle of Cobb Ave. It's real, unbelievable. Gloves and sticks are everywhere. The Eagles win, the Eagles win. Oh my goodness, what a game. What a moment for the Boston College Eagles.
The banner is being carried on the ice.
Wow.
The gloves are down. Just yesterday, the BU banner was hanging on the Hockey's championship. Today, it will be Boston College.
Oh man. What an incredible feeling. I'm at a loss of words. Seriously, you know, we only have one more championship to get, and that's the national championship, and we're well on our way as one of the best teams, if not the best team, in the history of college hockey. Wow. Truly just a special scene on the ice. What an incredible, wow.
What a moment. For the Eagles faithful, the banner is down on the ice, and Boston College's name has been added to the bottom. 6-2 is your final score. Will Smith and Jacob Fowler are the heroes tonight for the Eagles faithful. We won. That's all I gotta say.
Just an incredible feeling. It really doesn't get better than this. Wow. You know, and actually, I think the only way it could get better than this is a national championship. And we're close. So we're going to have a handshake line from two teams that were nearly brawling.
Fans are throwing food on the ice.
Love it. Love it.
What a moment for Greg Brown and his team to win the Lou Lamoriello Hockey East Conference Championship. And what a moment for us, folks, as we've done a fantastic job covering this team all season. All of our hard work, all of their hard work has finally paid off as the Eagles have won the Hockey East Championship. Again, you're listening to WZBC Newton. My name is Jacob Lassner. I'm joined alongside in the booth by Brendan Mahoney and Reynolds Johnson. Have a night, Eagles fans. Have a night, people of Newton. Have a night, people of Boston. That'll do it for the call. We're going to send it back into the studio with Liam and Eleanor. Thank you guys for tuning in, and thank you, Liam and Eleanor, for helping us out.